This game will be your bag. Minnesota has Alvin Willie, the second leading scorer in the entire league, while the Chicago Sting will counter with Karl Heinz Grenitzer, leading goal scorer in the American Conference. Karl is going to be back with the starting lineups right after this message. When you say Budweiser, when you say Bud, you said a lot of things nobody else can say.
Metropolitan Stadium in Bloomington, Minnesota. Most of the tailgate picnics are over right now. The teams are just out on the field, just about ready for kickoff. Let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups. For the Chicago Sting, first in goal, young Paul Gino Strenicer at right back will be making that first start at the right back this season. Clyde Griffiths and Vim Van Hanigan will be in the center, and Bruce Wilson will be the left back. In midfield, Charlie Fikas, one of the top rookies in the NASL. Karl Heinz Grenitzer with 36 points, and Dickie Advocaat. Thomas Sjoberg will be the target man in the middle. Peter Russell and Jorgen Christensen will flank him, the wingers. For the Minnesota Kicks, in goal, a youngster from Simon Fraser University in Canada, 21-year-old Tino Letteri. Mike McClenaghan, his teammate from Simon Fraser, will be at right back. Steve Litton, Alan Merrick, two tough center backs, and Tony Wundt complete the defensive line for the Minnesota Kicks. Ace Netzelenghi, Bjorn Nordquist, and Alan West, top flight midfield for the Minnesota Kicks. Willie Morgan, a former member of the Chicago Sting, will be one forward, two twin strikers, two excellent players, Ron Futcher and Alan Willie. The Minnesota Kicks have scored 47. The Sting, 46. We're looking for all-out attack soccer tonight.
No question about it. The Minnesota Kicks have defeated the Chicago Sting in five of their six matches since they came into the league back in 1976. The last time we played these fellows was at Soldier Field. We lost 4-2, but two of those goals were put in by our own players. Unfortunately, Clyde Griffiths and Karl Heinz Grenitzer dented our own nets. Getting ready to go. This action is underway. Sting kicking off. Chicago in yellow jerseys, black pants. Minnesota in orange jerseys, blue pants, white numerals and trim. Chicago moving from your right to your left. And the Minnesota Kicks take over, moving toward the Sting goal, left to right. Nordqvist at the Sting 35. Ball intercepted by Chicago. Sjoberg to Christensen, taken away. Referee blows a whistle, a foul called on Minnesota. Kenny Stern, the Chicago Sting certainly has a patchwork defense in there tonight.
Yes, they certainly do. Four of Chicago's original defenders, roster defenders, Luigi Martini, Lothar Scala, Stefan Schaefer, and Derek Spalding are all injured, and they're going with two normal midfielders, Gene Strenicer and Willem van Hanegem in the back.
There's Gene Strenicer playing right back for the first time since he's joined the Sting organization. Karl Heinz Grenitzer now still in the midfield. Lays it up to Christensen, tries to put him in foul. Merrick can't do it. Nordqvist comes up with it. Bjorn Nordqvist, Swedish national player to West. He drives it deep into the Sting zone. Griffiths is going for it. He's going to let it go for Paul Coffey.
Gene Strenicer, although he came out at the right back, will actually be playing left back there, marking a tremendous player in Willie Morgan. And Bruce Wilson will push into the middle and mark Ron Futcher and look for Clive Griffiths to mark their scoring ace, Alan Willie.
And Van Hanegem, again at stopper tonight, still giving that injured leg a little time to rest. Bruce Wilson, Chicago team captain, starting his 143rd consecutive game. New league record every time he starts. Long pass to Fikas, dribbles out of bounds. It's a throw-in for Minnesota. Ace Nesselenkwe takes it deep in his own zone. Back to Tino Letteri. Letteri did a tremendous job against Chicago in the game against the Sting at Soldier Field. He's always been tough on the Sting. Letteri has earned the number one spot. Minnesota has sent Volkmar Gross to San Diego. So Letteri has it number one with Jeff Barnett, the reserve keeper. Battle for the ball at midfield. Sjoberg tried to signal the referee, Jim Hyatt, that a handball should be called, but there was no call, and the kick's coming out of their own zone. Dark kicked away. Willie Morgan has it, former Chicago Sting player a couple of years ago, quite a ball player. Gets by Strenicer, but taken away. Charlie Fikas, young Chicagoan from Wheaton, Illinois, played his ball at Indiana, one of the leading contenders for Rookie of the Year honors in the North American Soccer League. Charlie has two goals and five assists in regulation play. Been quite a great surprise. Willie Roy has big plans for Charlie Fikas. Willie Roy, the Sting coach. Karl Heinz Grenitzer breaking now beyond the 35-yard line, moving in. He's got Benegum to beat, goes to Christensen. Christensen trying to get around Alan Merrick. The ball is tapped over the end line, coming up on the first corner kick. When the ball is last touched by the defense, before it goes over the end line, the offensive team is awarded a free kick from the nearest corner to where the ball went out. It's called a corner kick, and Jorgen Christensen's going to take it. There's the cross, Joberg the header, headed out, take him back to Renitza, slows it down, goes to shoot, fires, but it's an easy one at Tino Letteri. First shot of the ball game, fielded easily by Tino Letteri. Terry's not a big guy as goalkeepers go. He's 5'8", 170, covers a lot of ground, has tremendous spring in his legs, and cat quick reflexes. Tony Watt on the far side, laying it up to Alan Willie. Willie with 17 goals, the second leading scorer in the entire North American Soccer League, trailing only Giorgio Canali of the Cosmos. Now it comes to Nordqvist. Minnesota, the kick's moving left to right early in the ballgame. No score, NASL Enkwe. Trying to penetrate the 35-yard line. Vikas has him boxed out. He goes to Futcher, broken up by Wilson. Vikas able to tap it to Grinitza. Jorgen Christensen. Dickie Advocat on the far side. The workhorse of the Chicago Sting staff. Up and back. There's a long lead toward the quick Peter Ressel. Ressel toward the penalty area. He goes down. Tony Watt with it now. Peter Ressel making a run. First good run of the game. Blunt drops it back to Merrick. No score in the ballgame. Lead comes to Futcher. Broken up, however, by Bruce Wilson, driven out of bounds. It's going to be a throw-in for Minnesota.
The kids' gully, Tino Letteri, and Chicago reserve gully tonight, Tony Chersky, both have something in common, in Howard, and that they both played at the same university, Simon Fraser University, from British Columbia. Both of them were goalkeepers. Of course, at different times at that school.
There's Alan West breaking into the Sting attack zone. Carl Gunitz on him. West looking for a little room to cross. Carl staying with him. There's the cross, headed away by Vikas. Jorgen Christensen drops it back for Wilson, almost intercepted. Check that was Strenicer. And here comes Jorgen Christensen. Carl Gunitz. Ball is driven by Charlie Fikes, now over to Dick Advocat. That's a 35-yard line. Dick's in almost inside the attack zone. Comes back to Clive Griffiths. Now over to Captain Wilson. Sting setting up the attack. Early going. First half, no score. Christensen. Now to Dick Advocat coming. Goes to Griffiths. Griffiths trying to get around one man. Ball kicked away, and Merrick is there for Minnesota. Controlling. McGlinnigan. Up over the 35-yard line they go, and here comes Alan Willie. Crowd really goes crazy here when Alan Willie gets his toe on the ball, drops it back to Nordqvist. Tony Watt, who's come up from his left back spot, tries to go to Nordqvist, sliding tackle. Nordqvist still has it in the corner. There's the cross. Coffee watches it sail on the back of the post. Goal kick coming up for the Chicago Sting. Ball last touched by the offense before it went over the end line. The Sting is going to return to action on July 14th in Chicago when they meet the Tulsa Roughnecks at Wrigley Field at 3:30 p.m. You want to be on hand as the Sting really starts making its drive toward the playoffs, still shooting for that first place spot, trailing Houston, but still 10 games to go. Get a free Budweiser cushion, enjoy the exciting soccer action, call 558-KICK. 558-KICK for ticket information. Chicago Sting against the Tulsa Roughnecks is coming Saturday afternoon at 3:30 Wrigley Field. There's a shot by Christensen, handled easily by Letteri. By the way, I don't know if you fellas knew this or not, but in that ball game this coming Saturday, if any fan brings a new or used album to that game, they get a dollar off the price of any seat because those records are going to go to support the Les Turner ALS Foundation Music Park. Very good cause. Here's Fikas. Overleads his man. Merrick gets it to Tony Watt. Back to Nordqvist. Now Willie Morgan. You can always spot Morgan. For those of you watching the Minnesota kicks for the first time, he's the only fellow out there with a kerchief. Where's that headband? Morgan gets by Advocat. Morgan coming. He shoots, and it sails over the end line. It's going to be another goal kick for the Chicago Sting. Morgan, a long one that time.
Yes, Willie Morgan's a very, very difficult player to mark in that he's all over the field. He has something very in common with the Chicago Sting. Both of them are wingers, but they like to attack from the back. And, of course, this shows up in their statistics. Each player only has one goal, but a lot of assists.
Christensen now with it for Chicago. Right at the Sting 35-yard line, trying to get around Allen West. Sting going right to left. Scoreboard clock shows 37 minutes remaining in the first half. They play two 45-minute running time halves. Only timeout is for injury. Bruce Wilson, Sting captain, right at the midfield, gets around Allen Willie. Comes to the infield dirt here at the Met Stadium. There's a run with Nesalankwe, and finally Nesalankwe is able to tap that ball over the sideline, but the Sting is going to have a throw in deep in the Minnesota zone. Carl, there seems to be some interesting matchups out there tonight with Griffiths and Van Hannigan matched up against their double strikers, Willie and Futcher.
Those guys have their hands full, certainly, Howard. We're going to see how those things develop, and we'll highlight those for the folks at home as we get along.
Vikas. Benitza tries to go to Wilson, to Christensen, but the linesman on the near side, Brian Summersby, signals an offside against Chicago. Anytime inside the 35-yard line, a player passes a ball to another offensive player. There's a good shot of Alan Merrick, one of the very fine center backs in the game today. Anytime there's not two defenders between the attacker and the ball at the time the ball is passed to him, it's called offsides, and the other team gets the ball. Alan Merrick, by the way, is the fellow who kicked Peter Ressel's shot off the line in Chicago that would have tied the game at three, changed the whole game around with a great defensive move. Futcher. Griffiths is there to take it away to Bruce Wilson.
Howard, you mentioned Alan Merrick and Steve Litt. You look at the entire Kicks roster, and this 11 that they have out there has been intact all season long. And talking to Coach Roy McCrone on the way in, we were a bit envious because Roy has his entire club intact from the beginning of the season. The Sting has had to use a patchwork club for most of the second half anyway.
Derek Spaulding in the game. Luigi Martini in Chicago watching the game. Lothar Skala, Arno Steffenhagen, Stefan Schaefer. The list seems actually endless. But the Sting continues to rest in second place. Want to get some good wins, though. Make a real run at Houston. Karl-Heinz Grenitza now. Trying to get by Nordqvist. His lead broken up by Nesalankwe. To McGlinigan. To Willie Morgan. Ace Nesalankwe at his own 35-yard line. Pass broken up by Carl. Nordqvist tries to go to Futcher. Willie to Futcher. Futcher is broken inside the defense. However, the linesman on the far side, Rod Smithson, has signaled an offside against Minnesota. This crowd doesn't like it at all. We want to tell you folks the program is authorized under rights granted by the Chicago Sting Soccer Club solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for viewing or listening to this program without the express written consent of the Chicago Sting, is prohibited. Broadcasters for Sting telecasts are chosen by and are paid by the Chicago Sting.
Sure, we got a little bit of jawing down on the field there. Peter Ressel just got taken down, and referee Jim Hyatt, who's not known to blow his whistle a lot, did not call the foul, and Peter Ressel, I'm sure, was very upset, and Hyatt just turned around and gave him a throw-in. Here's a good shot of what I was just talking about. There's the ball. Peter Ressel put it by him, the tackle a little bit late, and Jim Hyatt singles the ball to go Minnesota's way. The ball did go off Peter last, but the player fouled him, and the foul should have been close.
In the meantime, a foul against Bruce Wilson has given Minnesota a free kick in the midfield. Less than 34 minutes remaining in the half, still no score. Here comes Willie. McGlinigan and Willie Morgan down over the ball. Morgan leaves it for McGlinigan. Puts it up into the penalty, towards the penalty area. It is headed off to the far side by Litt. It goes over the end line. It's going to be a goal kick for Chicago. There's still time to sign your child up for one of the Sting Soccer summer camps, including those in Skokie, Downers Grove, and Homewood. Coach Willie Roy runs a professional camp. These are daytime, week-long camps for your youngsters, and they're just terrific. So why don't you call the Sting office at 558-KICK for information on these camps. 558-KICK. Ron Futcher, running Bruce Wilson off the ball, gives it to Materi. Chicago Sting, remember, coming home Saturday afternoon against the Tulsa Roughnecks, 2,500 seat cushions, courtesy of Budweiser. Then the Sting will have a Wednesday evening game against the Memphis Rogues at Soldier Field. They're going to come right back to Soldier. There's a long, high drive toward the penalty area, but Coffee grabs it. The Sting will play on July 21st at Soldier Field, 7:30 on a Saturday evening, against the Tampa Bay Rowdies, Rodney Marsh, Fabiani and company. That game is going to be Just Pants night. The first 5,000 fans will get Frisbee-type flying discs from Just Pants. There's a lead. They're going for Fikas and Joburg, the two blonde bombers, breaking into the penalty area. And if you get to one of the great Just Pants stores in the Chicago area, you'll find a coupon that will get a youngster into that game, a teenager in for a dollar, and any adult can get in that game for half price with that coupon. These coupons are available only at the Just Pants stores, though. That's this coming, the 21st of July, Saturday evening. The Sting against Tampa Bay. However, this coming Saturday, Chicago finishes that three-game road trip tonight, and this Saturday, the tough Tulsa Roughnecks. And, man, they are a tough ball club. Wrigley Field, 3:30 p.m. Here comes Allen West. Allen West moving for Minnesota. There is the lead over the far side. Willie Morgan's got it. Always dangerous. He's coming in on Wilson. Morgan trying to break Wilson in the corner, and the ball goes over the end line. Let's see how they call it.
I think we're going to have a corner kick on this one.
Corner kick coming up, Kenny.
Very good move here by Willie Morgan. I really wish Bruce Wilson would take him outside the penalty box. But Bruce did make a good play to slide the ball out of bounds, but he really should take him on the penalty box. So if he fouls him, there is no penalty kick.
All right, getting ready for the corner kick. Willie breaks as the cross comes in front, headed out. I think that was actually fisted out by Coffey. Ball goes to Futcher on the far side. Allen West. West crosses again. Futcher goes up in the air, heads it down toward Litt. He puts one high in the air, and it goes over the end line. All right, the score out here, 0-0 with less than 31 minutes to go in the half, and we'll be back after this word. Back to the action at the Met in Bloomington. Howard Balson with Carl Churkin and Ken Stern. Sting nothing, Minnesota kicks nothing. A foul against Tommy Joburg gives Minnesota a free kick at the midfield. Tony Wundt moving the ball upfield to the Sting 35-yard line. That's back to West. And it comes toward the penalty area. And Van Hannigan lets it roll to Paul Coffey. Crowd out a little bit excited. We weren't excited, were we?
Not at all.
Mm-mm. Coffey lays it out to Charlie Ficus. American. Five Griffins. Finally ends up on the foot of Vim Van Hannigan. Goes over on the far side to Gene Strenicer, making his first start as a right back with all the Sting injuries. Spalding, Martini, Schaefer, Scala. Abicott for Chicago to Carl Heinz Grunetza. Leading goal getter in the American Conference. He drives a long drive to the far side, but it sails. Pat Schoberg out of bounds, a throw in for Minnesota. You know, if you're a club or organization who would like to come out to a Sting game, the Chicago Sting has some terrific group discount plans. They will make it very, very appealing for your club or group to come on out. Just call 558-KICK. That's 558-KICK for information on the those group plans. Van Hannigan trying to come out of his own zone for Chicago. Griffiths to Grunitza. Still moving, got by Futcher, gets by Morgan. Grunitza inside the 35. He's trying to go to wrestle, but it's kicked away. Hustling Gene Strenicer with it down. Abicott. Give and go, broken up by Minnesota. However, Clive Griffiths there for the intercept at the midfield goes to Vim Van Hannigan.
Howard, we haven't seen very much of Alan Willie yet. We will before we're done. Number nine, he has 39 points, so the rest of the NASL has seen plenty of Mr. Willie already this year.
He scored against us once in that ballgame. Alan Willie is a tough scorer. He's all over the place. And another thing that impresses me is the way Ron Futcher, who is a striker, he does a lot of running for a striker. He is back and, you know, front and back all the time.
These guys really complement one another.
Yes, they do. Dangerous player, this Futcher.
But, of course, Willie Morgan sets it all up for him. Willie Morgan has played on a lot of teams where the strikers have scored a lot of goals. Frank Worthington at Bolton was a leading scorer in all of England. Worthington now with Philadelphia Fury was a leading scorer in all of England, and he accredits a lot of that to Willie Morgan.
Coach Willie Roy and Jim Walker have authored a book. Some of you fans... It's a very basic book, well illustrated, and it'll tell you how to coach youngsters. You know, there's a lot of youngsters in the Chicago area playing soccer. And this book will really give you an idea on how to coach them. Here's Willie trying to drive through two Chicago Sting players. Ficus goes down, able to get his foot on the ball. It goes over the end line. Let's see how Jim Hyatt, the referee, calls it. Charlie Ficus A last-minute tackle to drive that. Willie Morgan is coming to the near corner to take the corner kick. There's a shot at Charlie Ficus. Really coming on. Highest scoring rookie in the NASL thus far this season. Willie Morgan is crossing in front to Nesamekwe. Broken up momentarily. Ace gets it back to Morgan. Crosses again. Up they go for the header. It goes over the bar. Alan Willie sailed high in the air that time. Up over Clive Griffiths. Put it over the bar. It's going to be another goal kick for Chicago. Minnesota dominating the game. It's hard to say. I say that, and then I realize the Sting has spent quite a bit of time down there, too. Minnesota's had a little more of the dangerous scoring plays, however. Charlie with 2 goals and 5 assists, more than any other rookie, and there are a lot of people in the league office that are touting Charlie Ficus as rookie of the year.
Yes, he's been playing with a bit of a groin pull, too, the last 2 or 3 games. He pulled his groin a little bit against Fort Lauderdale 2 games ago before he scored the goal, incidentally. Managed to go half that game and half Detroit, and hopefully he'll be able to go a little bit longer tonight.
Scoreboard clock shows 25 minutes, 29 seconds remaining in the first half. No score. Dick Abbott for Chicago. He's picked up by West. Now he's got Futcher on him. Tries to go between the two and get it to Wim Van Hannigan. The Dutch master comes over the Sting 35-yard line. Picked up by Willie. The drive looking for Strenicer. Intercepted, however, by Ace Nesalentwe. Drops it back to McGlenigan. Right back to Ace. Ace moving upfield over midfield to Willie Morgan. A little bit of room. Morgan drives one toward Futcher. Kicked away by Van Hannigan. Joburg has it for Chicago. Give and go, but a handball called on Nordqvist as Christensen tried to go to Joburg. Hit Nordqvist on the arm. That's a no-no. Free kick to Advocat. He's trying to control it, but that ball was really driven over to the far side. Keep it in. Throw in for Minnesota. West will throw it in. Goes to Morgan. Comes to Futcher, but Griffiths gets there first and just kind of hops right over Ron Futcher. Little leapfrog there by Clive Griffiths. Finally, Jorgen Christensen. Nordqvist chasing him, and then he goes back to Advocat, but Dick had stopped. And the ball sails on by again, and a Minnesota kick throw in. Jorgen Christensen, the wizard of dribbling and setting up plays, misconnected on the last couple of passes. He's the all-time assist leader, 27 career assists. There's Alan Willie, Griffiths on him. Puts a good move on Griffiths, throws it to the top of the penalty area, but nobody there except Captain Bruce Wilson. Dickie Advocat now with it for Chicago. The Hustler moves over the 35. Sting coming on your screens right to left. Actually from the west end of the Met to the east. Back to Christensen. Back heels it easily to Dick Advocat. Try to go to Joburg. Foul called against Minnesota. Free kick for Chicago coming up. There's the free kick. It's moving into the penalty area. Joburg on the run. Check that was Ficus. However, Chicago is being nailed for an offsides.
Pretty good idea, though, Howard, trying to catch him, putting the ball in play quickly and trying to catch him napping.
Interested in playoff tickets, and this thing was very close to a playoff berth. They can be charged to your Master Charge and Visa Bank America cards. Calling 558-KICK right now for your tickets will ensure that you get some great seats for the playoffs games. That's 558-KICK. Ball rolls out over the end line.
Beautiful piece of work there by Jorgen Christensen losing his man. He tried to play it ahead to Karl-Heinz Grenitzer. He played a little bit too far ahead. We'll have a goal kick here for the Minnesota kick.
Unfortunately, he hit the infield dirt there, and the ball got a little bit away from him.
Both teams working very, very hard. Nobody really able to seize the advantage yet here, and we've got 22 minutes and 23 seconds left to go, Howard.
Mike McGlenigan up to Litt. Steve Litt, Sting 35. Long, high sailing pass. Charlie Ficus stands on it right at the end line, gives it to Paul Coffey. Now Wim Van Hannigan. The Sting nothing, Minnesota nothing. Clock shows 22 minutes remaining in the first half. Neither side has had what you would call a really dangerous scoring opportunity yet. Dick Advocat with it. He's being chased all over the place by Futcher. This Futcher just got to run out of gas a little bit in the second half. And Hannigan with the ball. Really is not back at 100% when he is. Man, that guy is some kind of a player. lead goes to Christensen, just able to get his foot on it. Van Hanna comes back to Joburg. Thought Christensen was breaking on the give and go. Jorgen was not, and the ball once again taken over by Steve Litt of the Minnesota Kicks. He goes to Mike McGlinigan, coming up the near side. Ace Nesavankwe. Far side, Tony Wan. Long, high drive, looking for Futcher, but it goes out of bounds. Throw in Chicago. Wilson with the ball for the Sting. Throws it back to the young American goalkeeper, Paul Coffey. Sting's first-round draft choice out of San Jose State. Right back to Captain Bruce Wilson. The Iron Man of the Chicago Sting. 143 consecutive starts since coming into pro soccer. Karl-Heinz Gunitza with it now. Over the midfield. Nordqvist on him. Puts one toward the penalty area. Joburg starting a run. He'll never get there in time, however. Tino Viteri is there, covered by Ace Nesavankwe.
Sting not pick. They're out from left field with these balls so far.
Ace avoids a tackle by Christensen. Nesavankwe still moving. Crowd gets excited. Gets to McGlinigan. Near side. McGlinigan throws it into the penalty area to Willie. Willie looking for the shot. A battle for the ball. And finally, Van Hanegem comes up with it for Chicago. Good defense that time. Clive Griffiths and Gene Strenicer, and now Litt puts it right back into Nordqvist. Nordqvist controlling for Minnesota. Kicks putting pressure on Willie Morgan. Nice Nesavankwe with it. Across, headed high by Wilson, headed toward the far side and over the end line. Bruce Wilson and Vim Van Hanegem doing yeoman work.
A super play here by Minnesota. Great buildup. Here's the first one there, and the player winds up to shoot it, and the second player comes and slides it, and he just kind of whiffs on it. He didn't get to the ball first there.
Okay, action resumes. Corner kick kicked away by Chicago. Nordqvist has it. Jorn Nordqvist back to Willie Morgan on the far side. Picked up by Karl Gunitza. He tries a cross, but Paul Coffey comes off the line and grabs it. So the pressure is off the Sting momentarily.
Bjorn Nordqvist is a fine player, the international star from Sweden. He and Thomas Joburg probably know one another for a number of years, but he's 36 years old and he plays like he's about 25.
There's a long, high drive looking for Christensen, but his head is out by McGlinigan. Mike McGlinigan heads that ball out, and Jorgen Christensen is going to throw it in for Chicago, deep in the Minnesota zone, near side. Sting looking for that go-ahead goal. Scoreless tie. Just under 19 minutes remaining in the half. Christensen, he waits. Looking for a man to break open. He's got Joburg deking in the penalty area. Goes to Fikas instead. Back to McGlinigan, kicks it up to Nordqvist. Intercepted, however, by Chicago. Strenicer on the near side. Takes the ball beyond the 35 to Griffiths. Gives ground. And Hannigan on the Sting side of the midfield. Throws it up to Fikas. To Strenicer. Back to Van Hanegem. Minnesota defense forcing the Chicago Sting. In the midfield, Dick Advocaat on the far side. Willie Morgan's on him as he comes to Tom Joburg. Joburg is dumped almost as he tries to get around Litt, but I think we're going to have a foul against Steve Litt, and the Sting is going to get a free kick from the midfield.
Yeah, Joburg was taken down. He tried to put the ball back into play very quickly. But Willie Morgan was right there, and so Willie Morgan blocked it. Of course, he wasn't 10 yards back, so it will be retaken right now by Karl-Heinz Gunitza.
All right. Karl fakes. Now he just taps it over to the side to Strenicer. To Jorgen Christensen. Skips by Jorgen, and the ball is going to slide out of bounds on the near side.
Howard, we haven't had much scoring here yet, but we probably will. Tampa got plenty of goals tonight, three of them by Oscar Fabiani. They beat the California Surf 4-1. Fabiani, with that hat trick, moves into second place in NASL scoring. He's now got 41 points. Looking forward to seeing him.
Okay, remember, July 14th, this is coming Saturday. The Sting comes home for a four-game homestand. In the first game, the 14th, at Wrigley Field at 3:30 against the Tulsa Roughnecks. And the first 2,500 fans are going to receive seat cushions, courtesy of Budweiser.
Gino Strenicer just dumped Willie Morgan on his cushion on that play, too.
Free kick coming up for Minnesota. Scoreboard clock running down toward the 17-minute mark. Still no score. Minnesota will have another free kick midway between the Sting 35-yard line and the top of that penalty area. There's another shot of it as Gino puts Willie down, and Willie's not too happy. Morgan takes it right back. Morgan coming top of the penalty area. He crosses. Coffey grabs it. takes it away from Ron Futcher. Good move by Paul Coffey that time. Jorgen Christensen with it now for Chicago. Leads it. McGlenigan and Litt chasing. Litt catching up as Carl stops action inside the 35. Carl waits. He's got Joburg in the penalty area far side. Sting player is down. Looks like Peter Ressel down as the ball is intercepted by West. Then he goes to Morgan. Peter Ressel looks like he's hurt over on the far side at midfield, holding his head. A pass intercepted by Charlie Ficus. Chicago has the ball. Referee Jim Hyatt is continuing play with 16:06 to go in the half. And finally, he has stopped time. Stop time as Peter Ressel is being attended to.
Yes, Peter Ressel and Willie Morgan passed each other there. I don't know what happened. Willie Morgan's holding his hands open right now saying he didn't do anything, but Peter Ressel went down, and he must have caught an elbow or a back of a hand or something.
All right, no score in the ballgame. 16:06 to go in the half, and we'll be back after this word.
Ball here, the cross with the right foot. Fletcher coming in. By, he takes a little swipe. That's not terribly legal. He hit Paul Coffey. Later on down the field, Peter Ressel got smacked in the face, and we saw him writhing in pain, rolling down on the field. The confrontation between Morgan and Gino Strenicer also led up to that play, so it looks like these boys are not terribly friendly with one another.
Kenny?
That's right. Fletcher definitely should have been cautioned for that. I'll tell you what, right now, Jim Hyatt is losing control of this game, and he better tighten things up very quickly, or things are going to get wild. These are two very skilled teams, and you don't want to see a wild game here. The ball being in the midfield there, the play should have been stopped anyways. Peter Ressel rolling around on the ground. It should not take a Chicago player to kick the ball 50 yards out of bounds for the referee to stop the game.
You're looking at Peter Ressel being attended to. There he was only momentarily holding his head.
Peter Russell's too one of the nicest guys in the league, Howard.
He certainly
is. Hit somebody,
he seems to be okay. Steve Douglas, the Sting trainer, and Willie Morgan are both over there. Willie seems genuinely concerned. Morgan, here comes Ressel. He's going to come back in the game. We're going to resume action again. I want to remind you folks that the Chicago Sting is traveling these days in handsome jeans provided by the 45 Great Just Pants stores of the Chicago area. Minnesota will have the throw in. Kind of expecting a 50-50 drop ball there on an injury timeout. Wasn't to be. Wilson kicks it up toward the midfield. However, Alan West is there for Minnesota. Back heels it over to Morgan. Morgan's got two men to beat. Can't do it. Good move that time by Chicago's Dick Advocat. Back to Carl Gunitza. Covered by Nordqvist. Goes to Christensen. Right back to Carl Gunitza. Jorn Nordqvist on him. Christensen moving through that center circle now. They give him a little bit of room. Now Dick Advocat. No score in the ballgame. Sting would love to get that go-ahead goal on the board before the half ends. There's the lead to Dick Advocat racing. Hey, good move by Advocat. Took the ball, got control of it. It just was threatening. Now he goes to Peter Ressel. Ressel drops it back. Finally pushed out to Christensen, but it's pushed too far for Christensen. And Nordqvist comes back with it. The Sting looked like they had something going that time. Here's Nordqvist going to McGlenigan. McGlenigan is picked up as he comes into the penalty area. Van Hannigan on him. He has to take it out of the penalty area. Van Hannigan, the sliding tackle. Willie Morgan, and Strenicer is dumped by the referee. Strenicer tripped over the referee, and the referee is stopping time, and he really shouldn't have done that, Ken.
He called a foul on that one, I think. I have no idea what's going on there, but the referee's got to be looking around him a little bit more. Of course Gino was, a bit unlucky there, because Gino would have won that ball, no question about it, unless he ran into the referee, but what can you do?
Ball comes out, there's the return, it goes wide as Bjorn Nordqvist hits a bullet, but it goes off the end line, and it's going to be a goal kick for Chicago. Ball Coffey lays it down in the box. Bruce Wilson on the far side, but Alan Woolley's covering him. So instead of dropping it off, Paul is going to drive it upfield. Taken by Chicago, Dick Advocat with it. The lead to Granitza, too far for him. Kicked up to midfield, Nesalunkwe. Christensen, good move, takes it away from Ace Nesalunkwe. Trying to move around McGlenigan. Back to Dick Advocat. There's the long lead to Granitza on the far side. That ball is really running. Carl slows it down. Nordqvist on him, now one. Carl puts it back to Ressel. Peter, far side of the area. He crosses Joburg's header. Just grabbed on the line by Lettieri. Just grabbed by Tino Lettieri. A beautiful header. Leterry made a great save.
Tino Leterry, the young man from Simon Fraser University, really outdid himself on that one. Here's the play right here. Peter Russell with the ball just outside the box, the chip into the box. Joubert gets his head to it, a beautiful save there. Tino just about gets it, almost gets out of his reach. The left hand brings it back in, and we're back to action now, Howard.
All right, Willie Morgan moving inside the penalty area. Goes to McLenaghan. He crosses, headed in. No, hit the post! Fletcher hit the post. That brings it to Christensen. That ball from here looked like it was had goal written on it all the way. I was about to say it was headed in, and it hit the upright and came right out.
Certainly did. Here's a fine cross by the young Canadian boy. And there's Fletcher on the header. Paul Coffey coming out of the net. He could not get the ball. If he's going to come out on that one, he sure needs to get a hold of the ball. But it was a fine play on Minnesota's part, and you have to give them credit. And Fletcher a bit unlucky on the header.
Talk about your end-to-end action. First, Chicago has a goal wiped out and a great save by the crossbar helps. There's Alan Willie on the near side. Picked up by Van Hannigan. To Willie Morgan. Ministers on him. Back comes on McLenaghan. He shoots. Coffey goes high to grab it. Paul in good position for that one.
Howard, we're seeing a lot of good high balls, a lot of good crosses coming in from the Minnesota Kicks. Paul Coffey, if he's had a weakness this year, it's been coming off the line. He's a young player. It's a very, very hard skill to master when to come off, when to stay back.
Interception by Minnesota. Nesalenkwe with it over to Tony Wan. Wan's picked up at midfield by Russell. With a little bit of room, he goes to West. Back to Wan. Leads to Fletcher. Ball driven away by Wilson, and it goes out. Last touch by Fletcher. Fletcher trying to regain control, was the last man to touch it. Therefore, the ball goes over to the Chicago Sting. And remember, the magic number in Chicago is 558-KICK, and the Sting has people on the office right now. 558-KICK. Ticket information on the Tulsa game coming up July 14th at Wrigley Field in the afternoon, the Memphis game Wednesday evening, and then the Tampa Bay game a week from Saturday evening, the 21st. Both of those games at Soldier Field. Here's West to Morgan. Morgan's got some room. Van Hannigan picks it up. Morgan crosses. Up goes Fletcher. Heads it over the end line. It's going to be a goal kick for Chicago, and they are complaining, of course, that Fletcher was roughed up by Bruce Wilson in the box. There's Fletcher and Wilson, and they're talking together.
I think complaints going both ways on that. It looked to me like Fletcher climbed right up Bruce Wilson's back and on that one, and I think Bruce was a little bit upset himself.
Here's a drive by Paul Coffey upfield, intercepted by Tony Wan to Fletcher. Ball kicked by Alan Willie, puts it in the penalty area. Coffey comes. Looking for Ficus, trying to catch up to it in the corner. Just does keep it in bounds. However, Minnesota's Nordqvist got back quickly and has control. Now to Leterry. Leterry has made the big save of the game off the header by Joberg. And credit the upright with another super save off a beautiful header by Ron Fletcher. Fletcher, no stranger to goal scoring. By golly, he has 8 already. He got one against Chicago and could have had 4 or 5. Nordqvist, no score in the ball game. We're under 10 minutes now in the first half. The Selenkwe shot, and it goes off to the near side. It's going to be a goal kick for Chicago. Ace took one, and the crowd oohed and aahed. But with no score, less than 10 minutes to go in the half, we're going to be back after this word. Howard Balson with Carl Churkin, Ken Stern at the Met in Bloomington. Ben Van Hannigan with the ball, no score. But while we're away, both sides had good, strong attacks broken up at the last possible moment by the goalkeepers. Jorgen Christensen with it for Chicago. Clock running down toward the 8-minute mark. No score as Van Hannigan along the long drive intended for Russell, way over Russell's head, and Tino Leterry just grabs it on the first half. First bounce. In the old days, let's call that bouncer flying. Get out of the first bounce, Russell's out. Up come the Minnesota Kicks. To Fletcher. Fletcher battling Griffiths. Griffiths rams into Fletcher. Down he goes at the 35. Foul called on Clive Griffiths. And the Minnesota Kicks are going to have a free kick. I think Hyatt is talking to Fletcher and probably yelling something over at Griffiths. They've had a pretty good duel, too. Fletcher seems to be mixing it up with everybody.
Good call by the referee on that one there. Clive went through.
There goes into the box. Headed out by Van Hannigan. Headed back by Morgan. Ficus goes high in the air. Pushes it to the 35 where Russell makes it. For Chicago. Up to Jorgen Christensen. deflected momentarily. Gargan gets it back. Gene Strenicer with it. Almost makes... And Griffiths has to go back to the goalkeeper as Strenicer, dangerous pass back to Griffiths, almost intercepted by Futcher. That Futcher is all over the place. He's like wallpaper. He covers everything. Here's Bruce Wilson. The Chicago Sting making a run at first place. This is a big game for Chicago. Right here on Channel 32, they defeated Fort Lauderdale 3-2 in a real barn burner July 4th, and then in front of a national television audience. There's a long drive into the penalty area when Terry grabs it. Last Saturday, the Chicago Sting lost in a shootout to Detroit 6-5, but in so doing, they made perhaps the greatest comeback ever made in the North American Soccer League with the tying two goals in the last minute and 23 seconds. And now they're up against the tough Minnesota Kicks, and they come back for a four-game homestand. You want to get out there and see them. That's the left way to Morgan on the near side, picked up by Strenicer. Morgan. Left-footed pass up to Futcher. Looked like a shot at first, but Futcher was there to get it. McLennigan tries to go to Willie, headed away by Advocat. Taking right one. One put down by Advocat, and Granitza kicks the ball out of danger upfield. Alan Merrick is with it. He overleads West, and Granitza... He's going to let that ball roll out of bounds. It does. West tries to save it, and he can't do it.
I think Chicago will be very content to go into the locker room with a 0-0 tie here. They will turn around, and Chicago will have the better part of the field to be attacking on. I think they, not to take anything away from the Minnesota defense, they played very well in the first half. Chicago's been frustrated also by that dirt infield, I think, a bit.
At halftime, Carl Churkin is going to be talking to the public relations director of the Chicago Sting, Jerry Epstein, who's going to... Tell the fans about a brand new fun idea the Sting has come up with for the balance of the season. Granitza controlling. Oh, boy, he and West go right to it. Thought they might call a dangerous play there, but they didn't. Nordquist comes up with it for Minnesota to Morgan. Morgan moving toward the penalty area, crosses again to Futcher, kicked away by Wilson. Nordquist is right back. Minnesota putting the pressure on. 5.5 minutes to go. There's another cross. Coffey is tracking it, and he grabs it. Paul Coffey! Really stretched that 6'1", 170-pound frame in the air.
Here's McLennigan again. He's been very dangerous with those crosses, and this is what I think Sting fans are going to be looking at maybe for the next 10 years or so on Paul Coffey. Goes way out, stretches his arms, and he's a dominating goalie on that one that Chicago coach Willie Roy's looking for.
All right, Christensen with it. Almost run off the ball by Litt. Keeps control. Moves it inside toward Granitza, broken up by Nordqvist. Christensen gets it back. And the ball kicked away by Wanta West. Well, if Coffey keeps stretching that 6'1 frame, in a couple of years, he's going to be 7 feet tall. There's the drive toward the penalty area. The dangerous Alan Willie with it, looking for the shot. And he just pushes it off to the far side. Alan Willie beat two or three Sting players as he went for it. And now he and Coffey. And now that's Futcher. Futcher, Coffey again.
What's happening here is they wanted to get a corner kick out of the whole thing. And they were trying to take the ball away. And I'll tell you, quite honestly, the referee pointed there to begin with.
Watch Alan Willie. Man, look at what he does to us.
I think he had a legitimate complaint there. It looked like Clive Griffiths made a very fine play to slide that one over the end line, and the referee did give Chicago the goal kick.
In the meantime, Futcher, who is, I think, really looking for a yellow card. I mean, he is really asking for it.
Yes, he's had five of them.
He rammed into Paul Coffey again. He's had five yellow cards. He got one against
five,
us.
And he's been ejected also. Ron Futcher is probably... spent more time serving suspensions in this league than any other striker in the league. I know he and Steve Petcher have had about two or three fights through their careers. Steve Petcher, the Dallas Tornado.
Well, he has swiped a Coffey in the eye. He's rammed into Coffey. He put Russell down for a few minutes, and I don't know if he's had anything except a naughty from the referee. Here's Christensen trying to control. Jorgen Christensen. Well, he's a wizard. I'd say Jorgen Christensen. When he's doing his dribbling wizardry, he's worth the price of admission. He is some kind of a dribbler. Joburg drops it back to Carl Heinz at the 35. Nesselankwe on him, and Nesselankwe takes it away.
I'd like to know where Jim Hyatt is. It's right in front. He's three or four plays in the last 5 minutes, Howard.
There's a foul as Russell dumps West. Russell helps him up, however. It's going to be a free kick for Minnesota. Now just over 3 minutes remaining in the first half. The Sting in Minnesota... still no score. Been a lot of physical contact. Usually these teams aren't quite that physical. But Futcher is really, I mean, he's going to get everybody physical if he keeps it up. At any rate, outside the 35-yard line, the short one to Willie Morgan. Tried to score on Russell. Does so. Goes to Tony Wands on the far side. Morgan in the corner. Battling to keep control of the ball. Last touch by Strenicer as it slipped out of bounds. Soda. Comes to Merrick. He crosses the NASL way, tries to stand up for the shot. Looking. Ball taken away. Van Hannegem moves it to Advocaat. Crowd wanted a penalty kick that time, but the Sting got the ball. They didn't get the man, and that's the big difference. Morgan battling Van Hannegem, and finally the ball is pushed out over the side. Advocaat is screaming now. Now we have just over 2 minutes remaining in the half. There's the cross out in front. Coffey goes up and grabs it. Man, oh man, can that Paul Coffey go up in the air? Carl Gunitsa, the long lead to Christensen. 35-yard line picked up by Nordqvist. To Dick Advocaat. His pass is intercepted by Ace Nesanakwe. We're under 2 minutes now. To Morgan on the far side, picked up by Wilson. Morgan goes through two players, Wilson and Morgan going, and it looks like the linesman had his flag up. Or do we have an offside? We'll have to wait and see.
We're going to have, I think, an obstruction. Here's the replay on this one. Willie Morgan, one of the best one-on-one players, and here he goes one-on-two and splits Wilson and Stranicer. Bruce does good just to hold him off there, otherwise he would have broken through. Good foul on Bruce Wilson's part.
Morgan's on the far side. He gets by Wilson. Morgan crosses, headed out by Ficus. Joburg trying for it. He can't get it. Nordqvist gets it back. 1:05 to go in the half. No score. And a long lead toward Nesalenkwe. Goes too far. And Charlie Ficus keeps that ball in at the end line. So the Sting is coming out of their own zone with less than a minute now to try to get the go-ahead goal. Ficus drives it upfield. But he just gives it away right to Minnesota's Steve Litt. He comes to McGlinigan. McGlinigan inside the Sting 35. Picked up by Ficus. He crosses to Willie. Willie goes down in the area. No call as the ball is pushed away. Van Hannegem again doing a masterful job on Willie. Now Granitza, but a sliding tackle by Merrick breaks it up. He goes to Willie Morgan. Morgan coming. And he just overleads McGlinigan. Just plain and simple overled McGlinigan, and it's going to be a goal kick for Chicago. We're down to 25 seconds remaining. And Carl and Jerry Epstein of the Stinger are going to talk about that goal crazy. Aren't you, Carl?
Well, they picked the right two guys to do it, didn't they, Howard?
They certainly did. I can't think of, you said it all. Remember the Sting against Tulsa this Saturday afternoon at Wrigley Field. Sting, after the long three-game homestand, interrupted only by a 2-0 victory over Nevstead in Chicago. But now they're coming home for four straight games. And Saturday afternoon, they're going to be tangling with Tulsa. And there is the whistle. The first half has come to an end. With the score, the Minnesota Kicks nothing, the Chicago Sting nothing.
Selected by Paul Gardner, editor of Soccer Express magazine, from the past week's NASL action.
This is Paul Gardner. This week we're in Tampa for the game between the Rowdies and the Houston Hurricanes. We're at the 64th minute with the Rowdies leading by 3-0.
Fabiani looking for a hat trick. Wegerle reads his hat trick. Still has two players lost.
Argentine born striker Oscar Fabiani with his third goal of the night and his second in just over a minute. This one resulted from some fine Tampa ball control and a string of no fewer than 9 consecutive passes. Takes on this fullback. Here he goes, faking first to his left, then to his right. Another defender, here you see him coming in, has to come over to help, leaving space behind him. Into that space runs Wes McLeod. Wegerle sees him, the ball is pushed to him. McLeod takes the ball, pulls the defenders over with him, then pushes it back, and a first-time shot from Oscar Fabiani. Final score, Tampa Bay 4, Houston 0.
Watch next week for the NA.
Welcome back, everybody, to Soccer Action from the Met at Bloomington, Minnesota. It's the Chicago Sting nothing, the Minnesota Kicks nothing. Howard Balson with Carl Chirkin and Ken Stern. Ken, the Chicago Sting and Met have both had some scoring chances. Both keepers played well. They both made a couple of good saves, but obviously some adjustments have to be made if the Sting is going to score against this tough Minnesota defense.
Yes, I certainly think so. I think Coach Willie Roy is going to wait, and he's going to go with the lineup and see what he could get out of his players. Honestly, I look for Steve Long to come in the game for Chicago before the evening's over. Steve has played very well in the last two games, both the exhibition game at Soldier Field and the game in Detroit where he scored the fourth goal for the Sting.
All right, looking at the Chicago Sting lineup as they're taking the field for the second half. There's a shot of the bench. Brett Hall is there. Steve Long is still on the bench. Tony Chersky in the red jersey in the blue pants. There's Horst Blankenberg. Starting the ball game apparently with the same club that played the first half. Christensen, Joburg, and Ressel up front. Advocaat, Granitz, and Ficus in the midfield. Wilson, Van Hanegem, Griffiths, and Strenicer in the back line, and Paul Coffey in the goal. Again, a reminder that Gene Strenicer is starting and playing in his first game at right back for the Sting, because all we have Derek Spaulding at home with an injury, and Stefan Schaefer with an injury, Luigi Martini with an injury. Luigi came back very well against Detroit, got two assists in the late going, and then injured himself in the exhibition game against the Danish team, Nesved. So he's out, and of course, Scala's still out. Minnesota kicking off to start the second half. The Kicks in orange jerseys, blue pants, orange hose, the Sting in yellow jerseys, black pants, black hose. Minnesota moving right to left. Nordqvist to Ace Nesalekwe. Off to Morgan, off on the far side. Here's McLennigan's cross, broken up, taken back by Nesalekwe. His shot sails over the end line. It's going to be a goal kick for the Chicago Sting. Last touch by the offense, they're going to give it to the defense. Carl, that seemed like a lot of fun. You and Jerry Epstein were talking about goal crazy for this Tulsa game, July 14th at Wrigley Field. Are you going to come in the crazy costume?
I usually do every time I
noticed that. In fact, I've stated on the air, on radio, and I have mentioned your wardrobe there, Carl.
Yes, thank you, Howard. Well, maybe I could go to Just Pants and get a new one, huh?
Well, maybe you can, Carl. Maybe you can. Here's Fletcher. Oh, West. West crossing. And he was looking for Willie, who was coming in from the far side, but that ball goes over the end line.
Howard, we just got a word past that earlier score we gave you, the Tampa Bay score, was probably not a final. We do not have a final in it yet, but Oscar Fabiani has scored 5 goals. We've just learned from the press box here in Minnesota. Great night. Unbelievable.
That ties him with a lot of players, including Chicago's own Ron Moore 2 years ago. Remember when Ron scored 5 against Vancouver?
That's right. And of course, the great Trevor Francis scored 5 along with Mike Flanagan last year.
They got a boy in this ball called Alan Willie who scored 5. Here's Granitza overrunning the ball. Kyle Granitza had a great run right to the top of the area and overran the ball, and there's no one more disgusted than Carl Heinz. Second, I should say, the leading goal scorer in the American Conference with 16. Minnesota coming back now. Willie Morgan. Early going, second half, no score. Nesalekwe on the far side. He crosses in front, and the ball is deflected into the net.
Ron Fletcher.
Ron Fletcher on that cross, pushed that ball past Paul Coffey, and the Minnesota Kicks lead 1-0. There's Fletcher, his 9th goal of the season.
Yes, Ron Fletcher scores his 9th goal of the season. He has 19 points. Came from a great pass by Ace Nesalekwe. But a player like Nesalekwe, how can you leave him alone so close to the goal, although he was at an angle? Here we have the replay. Morgan puts a beautiful pass through to Nesalekwe. I'm sure Morgan will get an assist on this one, too. Nesalekwe onside, drills one right into the middle. Fletcher just sticks his head down there. Paul Coffey really doesn't have much of a chance at all on that one.
As the fans can see from the replay, from our angle, the angle in which we're viewing, we couldn't tell whether Fletcher hit it or Van Hanegem backs into it. There's a shot going over the bar by Chikas, the young rookie from Wheaton, Illinois, by way of Indiana University, just fired one over the bar, a goal kick. Kenny, from our angle, I really couldn't tell whether Fletcher's header actually put it in or it was deflected off of Van Hanegem, but it obviously was Fletcher now.
Yes, Fletcher just stuck his head right in there. Tough player, Ron Fletcher. But, you know, again, as I said before, Ace Nesalekwe left unmarked that close to the goal. And what can you do?
So it's 1-0, Minnesota leading. 41-42 to go in the ball game. Van Hanegem running the ball down into the penalty area for Chicago. We're waiting for the official stats, but it sure didn't take the Kicks long.
I'm sure Morgan will get an assist along with Ace Nesalekwe.
Bruce Wilson for Chicago, then Van Hanegem. This may open up the attack a little bit for Chicago. There's a drive to the far side. They've got Ressel. Lit on Ressel. Back it comes to Strenicer, and the ball kicked away, but Van Hanegem intercepts for Chicago to Dick Advocaat, to Karl-Heinz Granitza. Granitza at the 35. Granitza shoots, and it goes over the bar. Carl took one that time from about, I'd say about 30, 31 yards out, and the ball sailed over the bar. Another goal kick coming up for the Minnesota Kicks. Say, why not join these others at the Sting's next home game, July 14th at Wrigley Field? Coming to the game will be groups from Anheuser-Busch, the Carpenter School Cup Pack 204 of Park Ridge, the Chicago Campers Council of Northwestern University, and 2 groups from the Chicago Department of Human Services. There's Minnesota on the attack. Alan Willie coming. The goalkeeper's out. Willie shoots and scores. Alan Willie, their leading scorer. Chicago Sting defense disappear as he broke through. Goalkeeper Paul Coffey came out. Willie beat him easily, and Minnesota now has a two-goal lead.
Yes, Toots Sting going after the same ball. Communication problem there. It looked like Clive Griffiths and Willem van Hanegem going after the same ball. And, of course, Alan Willie sticks it in. And Alan Willie sure isn't going to waste an opportunity. His 18th goal of the season.
Well, Chicago trailed three times by two goals against Detroit and came back every time to tie. So let's see what they can do here against this tough Minnesota Kicks team. Here comes Willie Morgan. There's the cross, and it is headed over the bar. Bruce Wilson able to come up in the air and head that crossing pass over the bar. Minnesota's going to have a corner kick, and right now the Minnesota Kicks are dominating this ball game with two quick goals for Alan Willie. That's his 18th goal of the season. There's a short corner. There's the cross. Header out in front. Broken up by Griffiths. Nordqvist is there. Intercept made by Abicott. He can't control it. Barrett goes to West. Futcher. 2-0 Minnesota. Futcher. 2-0 headed away by Charlie Ficus. Willie running it toward the end line. And it goes over. It's going to be a corner kick. Willie Morgan there. Morgan on the corner, he crosses in front, Nesalunque goes up, ball loose, and Coffey grabs it.
Ace Nesalunque gets an assist, a second assist of the game. And here we have a good look at the second goal. As two players come down, Bruce Wilson tries to tackle him. Paul Coffey coming out of the net, trying to cut down the angle. And Willie just beats both of them and slides it right in.
Here's Granita. He's leading Ressel. Ressel at the baseline, crosses in front, but the ball hits the side of the net. It went over the end line. Peter Ressel just didn't have any room that time as Carl Granitza pushed it through.
Peter's screaming. He felt that the defender deflected that ball out of bounds and was asking for the corner, but of course, referee Jim Hyatt did not acknowledge it.
Over 38 minutes remaining in the ballgame. Minnesota with two second-half goals has the lead. 2-0. Nesalunque off to the far side to Willie Morgan. He's got McGlennigan coming up behind him. Morgan moving. Now to McGlennigan. McGlennigan coming in unmarked inside the penalty area. Back out to Morgan. Morgan shoots. Over the bar it goes. It's going to be a goal kick for Chicago.
Also on the last goal, Gino Letteri, the goalkeeper, gets an assist, and he now gets his name in the statistic lineup. And I think what we're going to have here is a corner kick.
Willie Morgan standing over in the far corner at the west end. Southwest end. Morgan will take it. He crosses, it's a good cross. Futcher, the header, goes beyond him and Paul Coffey. Van Hanegem comes up with it for Chicago. Goes back to Coffey. So the two strikers for Minnesota, Futcher and Alan Willie, have put the ball for the Minnesota Kicks, and they lead 2-0. But I remind you, with just over 37 minutes left in this ball game, don't go away, because the Sting, with their explosive attack, has come back before. A foul called. I think that went on Futcher at the midfield. Free kick for Chicago. Karl-Heinz Granitza will take it. Lays it up to Ressel. Back to Granitza. Advocat to Griffiths. Sting pushing their defenders up. Griffiths inside the 35. Charlie Ficus tries to go to Ressel. Broke it up. Finally back to Ressel. Picked up by Merrick. Crosses to Advocat. Goes to Strenicer. Ressel. Give and go. Ressel coming in. Ressel breaking the penalty area. Puts it out in front. A shot. Granitza goes over the bar. Karl-Heinz Granitza. Look at him. Look at him on the ground. Pure disgust. A fiber of Karl-Heinz Granitza's body. A beautiful cross from Ressel. Carl had the goal all to himself and went over the bar.
There's the play. Jürgen Christensen plays it to Peter Ressel. Peter gets it through to Karl-Heinz. He just unloads a little bit too quickly. It goes over the crossbar. Howard, while we watch Karl-Heinz agonize over that missed chance there, I had my little pocket calculator out in the preceding couple of minutes. Alan Willie, with that goal he just scored a couple of moments ago, has now scored in six games. He has 41 points for the season. But more important now, how about this stat? Tino Letteri, the goalkeeper, has now gotten his second assist in as many games.
That ties him, I think, for an NASL record, two assists in a season. There's Nordqvist coming for Minnesota. He's leading to Willie, broken up by Ficus. Ficus gets by Futcher. But his pass is intercepted by Futcher, who came all the way back to Morgan. Sting trying to get a little more aggressive now. And they do get the ball away. Here's Christensen on the far side. Christensen moves toward the box, double teamed, and they take the ball away, and they return it to the goalkeeper, Vatteri, and he has to sprawl to save that ball from going over the end line.
Jorgen Christensen just got shoved right out of the penalty box on that one.
Minnesota coming, Alan West. He's got Want on the near side. Keeps it himself, and he shouldn't have because Dick Advocaat was right there for Chicago to take the ball away. Goes to Strenicer. Peter Ressel. Wrestled a long lead. He's got Granitza breaking toward the penalty area. Granitza slows it up, looking to get a shot away, pushes it to Joburg, and the goalkeeper, Vatteri, comes out. Joburg!
Howard, I think he was offside on that one. The linesman
right.
Put up the flag, and referee let it go, but I'm sure there would have been an appeal, and Joburg would have been called offside if he had scored. Incidentally, tonight's crowd, 20,733 fans here at Minnesota.
Well, the Sting trailing by two has started to open up now. The Sting is starting, they're starting to come. Don't go away. Joburg underleads Russell, comes back and gets it. Leads to Christensen. Jorgen coming toward the penalty area. Jorgen moving toward the baseline. He crosses in front, broken up. With 33:56 remaining in the game, trailing by two, the Chicago Sting has really started to open them up on all burners now. And they are coming. Karl Granitza missed what for him would normally be a sure goal, but the Sting continues to come. Finally, the ball kicked out of bounds over on the far side by Minnesota. Throw in for Chicago. Sting now trying to press. Van Hannigham to Christensen. He waits. Comes to Carl Heinz on the near side, racing to keep it in bounds. He's working with Joburg and with Advocaat. Goes to Advocaat. Advocaat to Van Hannigham. Van Hannigham pushes it through. He's got Ressel. The shot grabbed by Vatteri. Great save by Tino Vatteri. By Peter Ressel.
Dickie Advocaat plays the ball in there to Wim Van Hannigham. The Dutch master ahead to Peter Ressel. Turns. Nice play there. Beautiful diving save by Tino Vatteri.
Yes, I think actually Thomas Schoberg pulled through there and actually got the shot off.
Schoberg got his foot on it. Alan Willie on the near sideline. Great move by Van Hannigham to take the ball away and keep it in bounds. And Willie dumps Van Hannigham. Foul called against Alan Willie. Free kick Chicago. And Van Hannigham just pushes Alan Willie. Van Hannigham did. Well, that was just a great defensive move to tackle the ball, keep it in bounds.
Tim Van Hannigham on the ball here with Alan Willie. Goes for the tackle. He plays the ball, wins the ball. There's no reason for this, what we're going to see. We do not see it as we're back to live action here. Oh, no, there we go. Wim Van Hannigham gets pulled down. He gets 2 points in the calf roping contest there for Alan Willie.
Ball is driven upfield. Nordqvist there for the Minnesota Kicks. Comes to... Right back to Alan Merrick. Nordqvist. Sting going for the interception. Christensen barely misses, and McGlinigan gets it for Minnesota. Well, you can see Van Hannigham, Jorgen Christensen, Karl Granitza. This coming Saturday afternoon at Wrigley Field at 3:30 when the Sting hosts the Tulsa Roughnecks. First 2,500 fans receive Budweiser seat cushions, and if you bring a new or used album to the Sting Tulsa game, you'll get a dollar off the price of any ticket with the records going to support the Les Turner ALS Foundation Music Mart. The number to call at the Sting office for ticket information about this game or any of the remaining home games in Chicago is 558-KICK. That's 558-KICK. Sting has operators on duty right now. They can answer any question about the summer soccer camps or group ticket information. 558-KICK. All right, here we come. Peter Ressel trying to get around Alan West. He tries for the cross. The ball goes over the end line. They're going to give this thing a... Say it was last touched by Alan West.
Yes, that whole buildup... by a beautiful dummy by Jorgen Christensen. I don't know if you could remember it or not, but Jorgen stepped over the ball at midfield and left the ball for Karl-Heinz Granitza. Karl put Peter through and a good chance for Chicago all off a ball that wasn't.
There's an intercept off a pass by Karl Granitza. He tried to push it to Ressel, but West was there. Alan West having a fine man. There's a long lead to Alan Willie, but the goalkeeper Coffey fists it upfield. Charlie Ficus waiting. Coffey reacted quickly that time when it looked like Alan Willie might break through the Chicago defense. However, Minnesota comes up with the ball again. You guessed it, number 10, Alan West. Morgan seemed to dominate the first half. Alan West seems to say, hey, the second half is mine. All right, the Sting has under 31 minutes now. to get this ball game tied. They're trailing by two. Peter Russell on the near sideline. He's got Merrick to beat. He crosses this over Joburg's head. And McGlinigan pushes it right back to to the 35. Ficus battling for the ball. Can't control it. Willie Morgan does.
Beautiful play by Bjorn Nordquist on the tackle to win that ball.
And here's Carl Heinz Gunitza coming. Carl pushes it to Jorgen Christensen. Christensen looking. He's moving. He crosses. Russell's head ball. It scores! Peter Russell has put the Sting back in the ball game. A beautiful header off the cross from Jorgen Christensen.
Magnificent bit of ball handling here by Jorgen Christensen. He takes it there with the left foot, controls, beats McClanigan, goes down deep. The cross to Peter Russell. He's waiting at the far post. 2-1. The Sting is on the way back.
All right, the Sting is good back in the ball game. They're trailing now, but only 2-1, and we're going to be back after this word. Ladies and gentlemen, the Chicago Sting has just tied it up. Let's take a look. The Chicago Sting's Peter Russell has tied
equalizer with 28 minutes and 30 seconds left to go. Peter Russell, revenge for that poke he got in the earlier first half. Peter Russell controls the ball, beats Tino Letteri. We are tied now 2-2.
Same combination on that one. I'll tell you what, Jorgen Christensen with another beautiful pass to Russell. That's twice those two have combined on the team to tie up the game at 2-2. We got a brand new game.
Four goals in this half. What did I tell you? Don't give up on the Sting. Two goals is nothing to these guys. The Chicago Sting, an exclusive scoring ball club. Minnesota trying to attack. Griffiths puts it high in the air. That's going to bring rain. Joburg misses the header. Nordquist gets it to Salenkwe. He's coming. And a foul called against the Sting right outside the edge of the penalty area. Advocat.
I know what Advocate's saying right there. He's saying, good dive, Ace. But Ace Nesalinkwe goes down. He gets shoved a little bit and goes down. Ref's going to call it a lot of times, and it's a good play on Nesalinkwe's part.
All right, the clock shows 27-16 to go in the ballgame. We're tied at two. Peter Russell has scored his 8th and 9th goals of the season. Short corner. Litt shoots. He scores. Direct free kick, and let's take a look.
Yes, they moved a very good free kick. Willie Morgan gets another assist here. Litt shoots it right through two players, right at the near post, and sometimes the wall's going to get that one, sometimes it gets through, and very unfortunate that once again Chicago has come back from two goals down just to give up a quick goal like that.
All right, Sting has to come back again. Charlie Ficus and Litt battling for it. Litt comes out. You know, in taking a look at that replay, that ball may have been slightly deflected toward the near post.
Yes, that's a good possibility.
Loose ball at the midfield. Remember, later in the game, we're going to be announcing the Lipton T offensive and defensive players. Vim Van Hannigan, he takes a shot from Willie, keeps control. He goes to Russell. Russell moving in again. Russell tries to cross it, but the ball is deflected a bit by Tony Wan. And Minnesota comes out with it. So the Sting came back with two quick goals to tie it, and then Minnesota moved right back in on a blast off of a free kick by Steve Litt, his first goal, and they're ahead 3-2. What a ball game. Don't go away. Anything can happen. Here's Nesalenkwe shooting. Good save! Ace Nesalenkwe on a blast that Paul Coffey gathered in.
Paul came off very decisively that time and did get the ball.
Yes, but once again, there's Nesalenkwe from 20 yards out with a great chance to shoot, and you can't give them those opportunities.
Two of soccer's most explosive ball clubs really doing here. It's 3-2 Minnesota. Van Hannigan over to Strenicer. Back to Van Hannigan. Tries to beat Willie Morgan. Goes to inside the 35. Tries to go to Ficus. He slips and falls down on the grass, and Minnesota comes up with it again. But the Sting continuing to attack, continuing to put on pressure. Alan West keeps it in bounds. West controlling. He drives it up toward Alan Willie. Back it comes. That was Willie now. Willie on the far side of Willie Morgan. Morgan coming. Griffiths on Morgan. Griffiths chasing Morgan. There's a shot, and it goes over the bar by McGlinigan. The Chicago Sting and the Minnesota Kicks end-to-end soccer here. Minnesota and the Sting went to the halftime 0-0, but then goals by Futcher and Alan Willie gave Minnesota a 2-0 lead. Chicago tied it on a pair of goals by Peter Ressel, his eighth and ninth of the season. Then Minnesota came back, and on a free kick, Morgan, Steve Litt, and Litt booted it in. That makes it 3-2 Minnesota. That's where we stand. Clock showing just over 24 minutes remaining in the half in the ball game. You know, the Professional Soccer Reporters Association is going to have their first annual soccer awards dinner on Sunday, September 16th at Gus Mazzarini's Club Lago, a great Italian restaurant at Orleans and Superior. And there'll be a lot of Sting players there. And, of course, we'll be honoring Chicago. Men and women in Chicago have contributed to soccer. And you can get ticket information by calling Jerry Epstein. Here comes Willie Morgan inside the box. He throws it out in front, and Nesalekwe, with a great opportunity on the cross by Willie Morgan, goes over the bar.
That's a typical Willie Morgan play if I've ever seen one. Willie Morgan gets put through beautifully by number four Norquist there, coming in at a severe angle, but he won't shoot there. He'll pull it back. Nesalekwe can't ask for a better opportunity, and he knocks it, leans back a little bit, and knocks it over the bar.
Little tribute to Minnesota. Did you see the way Alan Willie let the ball go through to Nesalekwe? He could have stopped that ball, turned and shot, but he thought Ace had the better shot. All right, Chicago in control of the ball with 22 and a half minutes remaining in the ball game. They're trailing 3-2. Kenny, looks like we got a substitute coming in.
That's
for Chicago.
That's right. Steve Long has come into the game replacing Charlie Ficus. Willie Roy got 60 minutes out of Charlie Ficus tonight, and I'm sure he's very happy to get that much out of Charlie with the groin injury he's had.
Steve Long, he's lightning quick. Now, it'd be interesting to see how they play it. Will Jorgen Christensen drop back to the midfield and let Steve Long play that left wing post?
I think perhaps Stevie will come back into the midfield. He is very dangerous attacking out of the midfield with that great speed he has.
We're talking Gus Mazzarini is going to have one of his famous many-course Italian dinners in an open bar, all for $15. Call Jerry Epstein at the Sting office, 558-KICK. Minnesota trying to attack again, but Long comes out with it. Goes to Ressel for Joburg, but they miss connections in the middle of the field. And now Nesalekwe coming. Nesalekwe coming in. He's got Wilson. He crosses, grabbed by Coffey. Paul Coffey, the young American goalkeeper, Sting first-round draft choice from San Jose State. There's a shot of Steve Long. In Detroit, he scored his first professional goal. Brought the Sting back to 5-4, and Carl Granitza tied it up with 40 seconds left. Well, the Sting has come back from a two-goal deficit to tie it here. Minnesota's taken the lead. It's 3-2, but here comes the Sting. Jorgen Christensen moving, and the ball tackled away from him. Abbott is there. Feeds to Christensen. Christensen, his leg is locked, and there's no call. Will there be a call? Referee has stopped time. No, he hasn't stopped time, but he has stopped action.
Yes, I think he got that one on Litt. Jorgen tried to come away from, but Litt had his leg wrapped around Jorgen Christensen's leg, and I think what we'll have here is a direct free kick.
Now, if we do, the Sting will have an opportunity to do just what the Minnesota Kicks did, score off a direct free kick. They did it with Morgan Tablett, who scored his first goal. Now the ball is just outside the penalty area. Karl-Heinz Granitza appears to be the player taking the shot. Minnesota has the wall up. There you can count them. Five men in that wall. Carl goes into the ball. He drives it. Grabbed by Letteri. So with less than 21 minutes remaining in the ballgame, we pass the halfway point. In the second half, the Sting is trailing 3-2, but the Sting keeps attacking. And I have some good vibes about the Sting coming back in this one. There's a long drive upfield, and Vim Van Hanegem is going to run it down for Chicago deep in their own zone. Remember the Chicago Sting, three home games coming up. They've got Tulsa Saturday afternoon at Wrigley Field at 3:30. They've got Memphis at Soldier Field next Wednesday at 7:30. And then the Tampa Bay Rowdies, that big powerhouse from the National Conference coming in. Or check that, from the Eastern Division of the American Conference, coming in Saturday evening. Call 558-KICK is the Sting number for ticket information. There's a long drive headed by Litt off to the far side, intercepted by Chicago, however. Ressel, oh, he is really dumped from the side. He looks like he might be hurt.
Yeah, but Nesalekwe goes right over to him and says, I'm sorry, he apologizes. And that's a good move on Nesalekwe's part. I think actually he maybe should get a yellow card. There it is. That's a very deliberate
tackle. There's the cross. Ball, Granitza's header is grabbed, however. Carl couldn't get too much on that head ball, and Letteri grabs it. Time now shows 19 and a half minutes remaining in the ballgame. Sting trailing 3-2. All five goals have come in the second half. Jorgen, no, check that, Steve Long. Finally, Gene Strenis around the far side, picked up by Morgan. To Clive Griffiths. Van Hannigan to Bruce Wilson. Pushes it out. Christensen. Taps it back. There's a shot, a drive going over the crossbar by Peter Ressel. Another goal kick coming up for the Minnesota Kicks.
I'd like to see Jorgen Christensen handle the ball. Young Mr. McClanahan cannot stay with Jorgen Christensen. He's opened up on that left wing a couple of times. The youngster from Simon Fraser is a bit overmatched by the Danish master, can we call him?
You bet you can. A dribbling wizard, Jorgen Christensen. Wants to come out and welcome the Sting home for that four-game homestand. Come on out to Wrigley Field Saturday afternoon, July 14th. The Sting will be tangling with the tough Tulsa Roughnecks. There's a pass toward Carl Granitz. It's kicked upfield by Tony Watt, and he's got Alan West. Darkfist. For Willie shot deflected. Willie gets it right back. He throws one high in the air, and it goes over the bar. Alan Willie chipped one up that time and just missed the top of the crossbar. Well, the score out here is Minnesota 3, Chicago 2, and we're going to be back after.
Go down the ninth. There's about 15 minutes left in that game.
Chicago Sting summer camp program. That's a good thing to remember. They've still got several camps going on in the suburbs. Skokie, Downers Grove, and Homewood Flossmoor, the ones coming up now. Week-long daytime camps run by Willie Roy and a professional staff for your youngsters. 558 KICK. Kick. 558 Kick. That's the number to get camp information and group discount information. Don't forget to wear those crazy outfits to go crazy, rooting the Sting hopefully to first place as they go into the home stretch of the season. Willie Morgan collides out there with Strenicer. Ball goes out of bounds. Chicago. Less than 16 minutes now to go in the ball game. Sting trailing 3-2.
Gentlemen, a big record tonight. We want to go goal crazy. We need at least one more, but those two goals that the Sting scored earlier by Peter Ressel were scored within a minute and 29 seconds of one another. The old record was 2 minutes and 25 seconds. The Cosmos had that one last year on June 13th, so we don't have the equalizer yet. We're working towards that, but at least we got one record.
All right, there's a cross going up. Push back out in front, a shot, a score!
There's the equalizer!
The Sting has tied it up! Tommy Joburg for Chicago has tied up the ball game with just over 15 minutes to go in the game for Tommy Joburg, his sixth goal.
You talk about the blonde bomber, he gets the equalizer here at the end of this play. A beautiful cross again. This one gets a little snow on it when it comes down. The one-header there by Granitza goes past one player. Joburg puts it through past the diving Tino. We're tied at 3-3 with 15 minutes left.
Don't go away.
I'll tell you what, Steve Long will not get an assist on that play, but he's as much responsible as anybody. And there's an anguish on the face of the goalie, but Steve Long deserves an assist on that one.
He was hiding his face.
Steve Long let the ball go, and he certainly deserves a lot of credit for that goal as well.
Granitza will get one, and Christensen will get one. All right, the game tied at 3. The Sting has come back for the second time. Ball is pushed out of bounds by Bruce Wilson on the far side. It's going to be a throw-in for Chicago.
Let's talk about some more records. Let's talk about some more records, Howard. Maybe we'll get another goal. Huh?
All right, two goals by Ressel and one goal by Tommy Joburg, and the Sting has roared back to tie it up. Just over 14 minutes remaining, and remember, you can see the Sting in this explosive scoring attack in action this Saturday afternoon at 3:30 at Wrigley Field. The Sting against the tough Tulsa Roughnecks. And welcome back an old Sting, Alex Kotarek. There's a cross. Nesalankwe put the goal, but it goes over the end line. Last touch by Joburg. It's going to be a corner kick for the Minnesota Kicks.
Assist on that last goal. Go to Karl-Heinz Granitza, second of the game, and Jorgen Christensen, his third of the game. Jorgen Christensen is assisted now on all three of Chicago's second-half goals.
Just like old Dan said.
I'll tell you what, a lot of second-half scoring in the last week, Howard.
Six goals in this half. There's the cross in front. Ball is pushed out. Granitza goes for it. Watt pushes it back in, and now the ball is kicked out of bounds by Gene Strenicer. It's going to be a throw-in for Minnesota. We had eight goals, I believe, in the second half.
That's right.
in the Detroit game, and now we have six goals here. The throw in to Watt, back to West. He crosses, and it is headed by Van Hanegem, up and out, intercepted by Morgan. Morgan puts one up, and it is deflected over the bar by Coffey. Good throw save by Paul Coffey on that soaring shot by Willie Morgan.
Yes, Paul does what he... Willie Morgan, again, one of the most dangerous players in the league. Lost one, it's going over Paul's head. He's not going to take any chances on that one, and he bats it over the net, and that's what Paul should do on that one.
That ball was dipping, that'd have been in, too.
Looked like Artis Gilmore now, didn't he?
Boy, didn't he? I'll tell you, he's going to be 7 feet tall by the end of the season. Morgan on the corner kick. Another beautiful cross. Ball is pushed off to the top of the box. Crossed again and headed off to the side. Holy catfish, Steve Long almost put it the ball in our own net.
Yes, I'll tell you what, though. It's criminal to see what Futcher's getting away with on all these crosses and everything. Futcher's going immediately at Paul Coffey, and I don't know what the official's looking at there, but Paul Coffey didn't have a chance on that ball. Futcher was holding them down.
We got another record here, Howard. Maybe we'll get the go-ahead goal. Six goals in one half by both teams thus far. That's a new NASL record.
It can't be. There were eight goals in the second half scored in our game against Detroit Saturday.
That's a club record here for Minnesota.
Minnesota. Well, you got a little qualifier there. All right, the Sting now trying to get the go-ahead goal. They've tied it twice. Once they came back from behind by two goals. Then they had to come back from one. Here's Strenicer. Strenicer fires, and it goes over the end line. It's going to be a goal kick for Minnesota. This ball game all tied at three. Gino Strenicer playing in the back line tonight, a defender, because, well, Martini is hurt, Spalding is hurt. You probably heard it before, but the Sting injury list, especially in the defensive alignment, really is something. Scala is hurt, Schaefer is hurt. So we're using Van Hanegem, a midfielder in the back line, Strenicer, a midfielder in the back line. Clock shows just over 11 minutes remaining in the ball game, all tied at three. Here comes Merrick. Check that. It's Nordqvist. Ball broken up nicely by Steve Long. Taken back by Minnesota. They go to McLennigan on the far side. McLennigan drives it upfield looking for Futcher. Futcher makes the trap. Pushes it back. Play nicely by Vim Van Hanegem. He comes upfield. And here's the foot race. Peter Ressel coming. Ressel has got Merrick to beat. Ressel lays it off to Christensen. Christensen slips and falls down. Battle for the ball. Merrick and Christensen, and the referee is calling Christensen on a foul and giving Minnesota the ball.
That's right. I think he just Jorgen over the ball like that, and the referee called an obstruction on that one. Very unfortunately, there. Chicago showing its fast break on that one. Counterattack, and Jorgen fell down, unfortunately.
McLennigan for the Minnesota kicks goes to Nordqvist. Upfield it comes. Ace Nesalentwe there. Alan West, picked up by Joburg. Back to Ace Nesalenke. Puts it through to Willie. Willie to Watt. Watt crosses, and it goes over Futcher's head and over the end line. And we're going to have another goal kick for the Chicago Sting.
Minnesota's really working hard here, Howard. Eighth consecutive win here at the Met. If they get it, and we hope they don't, of course, it'll be 17 wins for them. That would be another club record. So
time is out on the field. They've stopped time at 9:54. Minnesota kick player is down to go in regulation time. Van Hanegem to Bruce Wilson, starting his 143rd straight game, an NASL record every time he starts a consecutive game. Then Van Hanegem pushes it up to Dickie Advocaat on the run. He tries to go to Joburg, kicked away by Juan. Strenicer comes, saves it for Gunitza, and he tries to push it through, but Christensen nor Ressel were coming. And the Chicago Sting loses control. McLennigan with the ball for Minnesota. Upfield, but Wilson on the header intercepts. He dumps Alan Willie. Willie is down. I'm not sure that there was that much contact, but Willie went down. There they come to Futcher. Futcher's up against Clive Griffiths. His uniform is half black from going on that infield grass. Futcher's coming. He crosses. Shoots. He scores. Jarn Nordqvist at the top of the penalty area takes the cross from Futcher and scores.
His first goal of the season.
So Litt and Nordqvist have both chipped in their first goals of the season. Sting now trails 4-3. Dick Advocaat was upended as he came into the penalty area. The Sting wanted a penalty kick. Everybody pointed toward the circle, but the referee looks like he's playing an indirect free kick.
That's got to be what it is. I guarantee you after the game, Chicago's going to be claiming they should have got a penalty here. Dick Advocate got knocked down as he broke through. The referee blew the whistle as he should. And here we go.
All right, Vim Van Hanegem and Christensen over the ball. They don't seem to be giving him 10 yards, and Van Hanegem is not going to shoot until they give him those 10 yards. He wants that line move. No, Van Hanegem now moving to the wall. Granitza shoots. Grabbed by Lettieri.
Perfect execution on offense and defense. Carl Heinz struck the ball very well. But Tino, here we take a look at it one more time. Carl Heinz strikes it to the short side. Lettieri diving to his left, grabs it, smothers it. 4-3, the Sting has to come back still one more time, Howard.
Clock running down now. We're at 7:42 to go in the ballgame. But remember, the Sting tied it up. They were down by 2 goals with a minute and 23 seconds to go at Detroit and tied it up. Minnesota has a throw-in from the far side. Willie Roy is still barking. There's a shot of Coach Willie Roy, the Chicago Sting, barking at the referee.
What is that gesture?
Looking for a penalty kick, but it wasn't to come. Vim Van Hanegem gets it for Chicago. Goes to Dick Advocaat. So the Sting has to come back one more time. They've come back twice. Out it comes to Strenicer. Strenicer puts it in the box toward Carl Heinz Granitza, and he can't control it. Came off his chest, can't control it, and Nordqvist has ahead goal just moments ago. Nesselenkwe pushes it forward to Tony Watt. He comes to Allen West, and Minnesota starts their attack. He's got Nesselenkwe breaking. He gives it to Ace. Picked up by Steve Long. Ace moves in. Cross it back to West. West crosses. It goes over the bar. It's going to be a goal kick for Chicago. Ball coffee. There's a shot of Allen West. He's played a great second half for the Minnesota Kicks.
Rosedale Chevrolet, the Minnesota Kicks official car dealer, has your key to the good time.
Ball coffee getting ready for that goal kick. Sting trailing 4-3. Ball comes upfield. Carl Gunitz is there for Chicago. Ball tackled away from him by Merrick, and it rolls over the sideline. Throw in for Chicago. Gunitz throws it to Joburg. Joburg traps it. Tries to move the ball. He's called. Referee says play on. Tino Lettieri has the ball for Minnesota. He goes to Litt. Back to Lettieri. 4-3. Minnesota leads. Less than 6 minutes to go in the ball game now. This has been a wide open game. Almost a mistake by Litt. He went back to Lettieri, and Carl Granitza waiting like a cat to pounce on it. But it went to no avail. Tony Watt with it now for Minnesota.
Sting needs the equalizer here with 5:35 to go. New York got the equalizer with just about 12 minutes to go. They're tied 1-1 with Seattle in New York. Just about 10 minutes left to go on that one.
There's a good sliding tackle by Van Hanegem. Here comes the Dutch master. He goes to Christensen. He shoots, and it goes over the bar. Jorgen hit a rocket from outside the penalty area, but it went over the bar. It's going to be a goal kick for the Minnesota Kicks.
Nice tackle on that one to Van Hanegem, and I have a feeling Jorgen's shot didn't miss by very much.
Man, this game was tied at halftime. Goals by Fletcher and Willie put Minnesota up by 2. Russell got 2 goals for Chicago. Then Litt scored off a free kick. That made it 3-2. Then Joburg got the equalizer, and then Nordqvist has put Minnesota in the lead, 4-3. 7 goals scored here in the second half. Van Hanegem gets by Nordqvist. He lays it out toward Long. Long is dumped in the penalty. We get a penalty kick. This time we're going to get a penalty kick.
No question about it. He got pulled down from behind, and the referee can't even call a direct one. I would look for Dickie Advocaat to take this one. Of course,
Peter Russell was the fellow who was dumped. I'm sorry, Kenny, go ahead.
Derek Smalley normally takes it. Here's the replay. No question he got taken down. What? Look at the feet tangle on this one. Great ball by Van Hanegem, and there he goes down. And I look for Dickie Advocaat to take it. Of course, Derek Smalley, who has taken the other 3 Chicago penalties this year, is still at home in Chicago watching the game right now, and I'll bet he wishes he was out there right now.
Can you imagine how Derek Smalley is agonizing? Rides out. Everyone else has to stand outside the penalty area. The goalkeeper must stay on his line until the shooter makes contact. So the goalkeeper, Lettieri, must guess which way Advocaat's going to go and dive that way. Time has stopped here. With the goalkeeper must stay on the line until that ball is kicked. Golden chance for the Sting to tie it up with 4.5 minutes to go. Here comes Advocaat. He scores. Advocaat puts it up in the upper right-hand corner of the net. He gets his first goal of the season, and the Sting has tied the ball game at 4.
Dickie Advocaat, Mr. Cool on that one. Just drilled his first goal of the season. I would love to take another look at that. Dickie Advocaat, wide shot, closing in, goes to the upper right-hand corner. Lettieri dives that way, but misses it. We're tied, 4 minutes and 30 seconds left to go, Kenny.
Yes, Lettieri also moved on that one, moved early. The goalie cannot move until the ball's hit. If he had stopped that, rightfully so, Advocaat would have been able to take another one, but of course, Advocaat makes it, so they're not going to... away from Chicago.
So the Stingers come back three times to tie. There's a drive toward the box, headed away by Griffiths, taken right back by Nordqvist. He's coming. Finally, the Sting gets back control of the ball. Dickie Advocaat, who got his first goal of the season on that penalty kick. Sting has tied the ball game up for the third time tonight. We're tied at four. We've never led. Here's Strenicer. All right, Christensen. Getting by Nesalenkwe, pushing it to Granitza. Carl out in front. They're trying to push it through, but they can't do it. Christensen couldn't follow it up, and Lettieri comes up with the ball. Less than 4 minutes to go in regulation. Man, and you're going to see action like this on the Sting homestand as Lettieri drives it forward toward the Sting penalty area. Griffiths heads it back toward the 35-yard line. Willie Morgan, one-on-one against Long. Pushes it through to Ace Nesalenkwe. Run off the ball by Granitza. And the ball is driven over the end line. Then I'm going to have a corner kick and listen to this crowd.
We talk about goal.
Willie Morgan off in the far corner with the headband. He crosses. Up they go. Coffey grabs it. Throws it upfield to Christensen. He's got Long breaking upfield. Jorgen keeps it himself. Now he goes to Long on the far side. Wrestle was switched to the near side as Long takes it. He's coming on Nordqvist. Long fires and is deflected. Lettieri goes for it and grabs it. Long trying a long shot. It was deflected and Lettieri was able to make the stop. Less than 3 minutes to go in regulation. All tied at four. Ball driven upfield over Advocaat's head. Futcher traps it, but Clive Griffiths is there for the Sting. And Futcher just smashes into Griffiths. No call. Clive gets up and Futcher dumps him again. And here comes Carl Granitza up to Strenicer. Up on the far side to Steve Long.
Futcher just loves James Hyatt as a referee.
As Long goes for it, the ball was tapped out. Last touch by Morgan. A Sting throw-in from the far side. Clock running down toward the two-minute mark. Christensen. He goes to Long, but he overleads him. And the ball is going to be thrown. A check there. That was Peter Ressel. He overleads him, and Tino Lettieri has it. Less than 2 minutes to go now in regulation. The Sting in Minnesota tied at four. Lettieri drives it upfield looking toward Futcher for Willie. Battle for the ball. Alan Willie to Ace Nesalenkwe. The fans start getting excited as Ace waves Tony Watt up forward. He pushes it forward to Watt, but Long is there. Van Hannigan comes to help out. Long still has the ball in the penalty area. Battle for it. Van Hannigan with it, trying to keep control. And he pushes it inside. Great move by Vin Van Hannigan. The ball is finally pushed by Long to Nesalenkwe's interception. Ace gets around Advocaat. Coming. Nesalenkwe breaks in, but Joelberg is able to come and take the ball away.
Sting defense finally rising to the occasion now, not panicking, maintaining their cool and stopping the kicks.
Alan West battling for it with Joelberg. The Sting can't clear the zone. Now foul called on Joelberg. Free kick for Minnesota. Exactly 1 minute remaining in regulation time as Minnesota continuing the pressure. Merrick, and Merrick on his cross hits Alan West in the old noggin, and Paul Coffey comes up with it. All right, Coffey drives it upfield with 45 seconds remaining in regulation. Nobody there except McLennigan of the Minnesota Kicks at his own 35. Crowd on its feet again, roaring. Nordqvist. But he missed kicks it. Dick Advocaat comes for Chicago. 30 seconds remaining in the ballgame. Advocaat off to the far side of Peter Ressel. Ressel one-on-one against Litt. Ressel breaks the top of the area. Ressel shoots. Grabbed by Lettieri. Now there's 18 seconds remaining in the ballgame as Lettieri goes for Litt. He's got three bonus points here for the goals against Minnesota. They only give you bonus points for the first three. So he's got his 15, but right now he wants that win. Van Hannigan pushes it forward to Strenicer. Sting. Coming in the overtime, the same ball club. They haven't made any additional substitutions. Bruce Wilson moving for Chicago. Goes to Christensen. Ball tackled away. Willie Morgan has it. Morgan leads West. West up to Futcher, takes a shove from Apicat, pushes it back to Tony Watt. Less than 7 minutes to go in the sudden death. They go to Alan Willie. Willie trying to turn on Clive Griffiths. Back it comes to West. West against the rookie Steve Long from Wheaton College. He crosses in front, a shot, goes over the bar. Alan Willie took that good hard shot, went over the bar and to the near side.
The coronary unit, Alan Willie.
A couple of Alans combining on that one. Alan West, a veteran, very, very fine midfielder. Stevie Long doing the best he could on that one, left a nice pass. There's a good shot of it. And Alan Willie from very close in shoots and it goes over the bar, fortunately enough.
I don't think Willie Roy, the Sting coach, wants Steve Long isolated back there on the back line. Steve's a forward. Here's Paul Coffey for the goal kick for Chicago. Drives it forward. Less than 6.5 minutes to go. Joburg heads it high in the air, but Nordqvist is there. Puts it right back. Intercepted by Strenicer to Advocat. Kicked away by Minnesota. There's the give and go. Futcher to Willie, but Willie wasn't going. And the ball rolls all the way to Paul Coffey. Out it comes to Vim Van Hanigan. Over the midfield stripe to Dick Advocat on the far side. Dickie tied it up with his penalty kick goal, but Morgan intercepts the pass. Nesalankwe up to Futcher. But it goes out, throw in for Chicago at the midfield. Tied at four, we're in sudden death here at the Met in Bloomington. Howard Balson with Ken Stern and Carl Churkin. And we're having a foul called against Ace Nesalankwe inside the Minnesota 35-yard line. Ace is saying, no, no referee, he fouled me. But it's going to be Chicago's ball, free kick. Okay, Sting getting ready. Christensen drives it forward. Karl-Heinz Grunitza has it kicked away from him. Steve Long is there to help out at the 35. He goes right back toward Ressel, broken up, however, by Minnesota, and Willie Morgan comes out with the ball. Minnesota moving right to left. They go to Alan West. Long races to catch up. West in position for the cross. Up it comes, and the cross is grabbed by Coffey. This time, Paul in good position to take Ron Futcher's head ball. Now Christensen drops it for Strenicer off to the far side. Avocat picked up by McGlenigan. Avocat's pass broken up by Nesalankwe, but Carl Gunitz is in the path. Trying to move around Litt. There's a lead to Ressel. Ressel catches up to it outside the penalty area. Merrick on him. Ressel crosses, and it goes over the end line. And Christensen coming up hard on the near side couldn't catch up to it.
Howard, I would have thought a lot better if the Sting would have been able to win in regulation play. Checking the records this year in 1979, the Sting is 0-2 in overtime ball games and has won one of three that have gone into the shootout.
All right. Here's the Lipton offensive player of the game, Peter Ressel. Steve Long coming back quickly to take the ball away from Alan West.
Yes, two goals for Peter Ressel, as well as drawing the penalty on the time goal. So Peter Ressel is partly responsible for three goals.
There's Steve Long taking the pass from Christensen. Long is coming. Long puts it too far ahead of him, however. And the ball is tapped by Tony Wantzubateri, the goalkeeper. Less than 4 minutes to go in the sudden death. Too bad. Steve Long had a good run going. And now Nesalankwe in a foot race coming to the penalty area. He's fouled. A smart foul. Nesalankwe outside the penalty area.
Yes, no question about it. Actually, I think that was Gene Strenicer running step for step. Here's the replay on that.
You're right, that was
and
Strenicer.
Nesalankwe beat him, and Gene grabs him, and that's a very, very intelligent play. Gene gets a yellow card on this one, but it's well worth the yellow card there, so Chicago does not give up the winning goal. And although Gene Strenicer was yellow carded on that one, I'm sure Coach Willie Roy will not reprimand him.
Gene got the foul. I think Advocat got the yellow card. A dangerous situation here. 3:33 to go in the sudden death. Minnesota has a free kick right on the edge of the penalty area. Look at where that ball is. The Sting has a two-man wall. There's the cross. It is deflected by the wall. And it goes over the end line. And now Minnesota will take corner. Corner kick for Minnesota. Again, Morgan puts it up high in the air. Futcher's header goes across the bar. Grabbed by Paul Coffey.
Look at the shot Paul Coffey got. The referee did call that one.
And Coffey went into the net, but he held the ball forward, so the ball had not crossed the goal line.
Yes, but Alan Willie threw Coffey into the net.
Yes, he did.
That's a reason there.
He hammered him.
But that's a good point. He held the ball forward, and although he was in the net, if it hadn't been called, then you're correct.
There's Gunitza with the ball. Gunitza lays it through, trying to push it through. Referee says play on. They were going to call a foul on Gunitza, but as long as the Minnesota Kicks came up with the ball, referee said play on. And now Lettieri drives it into the Sting zone. Ball is headed high in the air, pushed off to the far side. Willie Morgan making a run. He's not going to be able to get there in time. It'll be a throw-in for Chicago. Just over 2.5 minutes remaining in the first sudden death. Sting's Christensen in control. He's coming. He's got Russell on the far side. Chicago trying for the attack. Jorgen Christensen looking for Gunitza. Christensen still keeps control of the ball. What a move. Takes a push. Still controls it. However, it's taken away from him. And Ace Nesalankwe lays it up to Futcher. Ball is kicked back toward the Minnesota zone. Joberg on the header. Watt over Joberg's head. Gets the ball up to Alan West. To Ace Nesalankwe. Dick Advocaat covering. Danger. Danger at the net. And Steve Long is there to help out, and the ball is kicked over the end line. Last touch by Nesalankwe. It's going to be a goal kick for the Chicago Sting. There is Dick Advocaat, who has been given the Lipton Defensive Player Award. He was neck and neck with Vim Van Hanegem, and the Defensive Player of the Award went to Dick Advocaat.
The Litt from the kicks was in the running.
Yes,
too,
he
Howard,
certainly was. Litt's played a fine game, even though Litt was the guy who actually committed the penalty kick.
Dick Advocaat, though, worked so hard, he had to get something sooner or later.
Long, high drive upfield. Headed away, but intercepted by Strenicer. Lays it off for Dick Advocaat. Minute and 20 to go in the first sudden death. This game all knotted at 4. Advocaat standing on the ball. Morgan letting him make his move. Goes to Russell on the far side. And he is dumped out there. The ball goes out of bounds. Referee, I thought, had signaled a Sting throw-in, but now he is allowing play to continue with Minnesota in control. Nesalankwe with the ball. Coming on Steve Long. To West. Picked up by Griffiths. He's got Watt. Griffiths and Watt to the corner. There's the cross. Goes high in the air, out in front. Alan Willie with it. Caught off the ball. And finally, the Sting comes out. Danger, danger. Here's Christensen. Jorgen on a big run. He's got Gunitza with him. He's got Joberg. He tries to go to Joberg, but he overleads him, and Lettieri gets it.
Jorgen looks like he's trying to do a little bit too much by himself here. He ought to slow down a little bit and relax.
30 seconds to go in the sudden death. Nordqvist coming. Griffiths, Nordqvist, outside the area, he crosses, Van Hanegem traps it, Bim in perfect spot, leads it up to Joberg, 17, now 16 seconds as Joberg starts a run, to Gunitza, ball taken away by Nordqvist, driven off to the far side, we're down to 7 seconds, but a foul has been called, however time is continuing to run in the sudden death, foul was against Karl-Heinz Gunitza, Morgan gets it. Referee is whistling play on, and the scoreboard clock shows no time left.
I just don't believe it.
It's true, Dicko. Just came over on the radio. They found her in a potato truck in Lincolnshire. The fellow at the pub where you worked identified her.
He knows where they found her. He put her.
What are you talking about? I haven't left this room all night.
Liar. I don't believe you.
Hetty, it doesn't matter whether you believe him or not, because it's said on the radio that Miss Milligan had been dead for at least 12 hours when they found her at 3 o'clock this morning. Now, that means that she must have been killed before 3 o'clock yesterday afternoon, and Dick was here with us from the time she left to the time he went to bed, so he couldn't have done it.
Poor kid.
I still don't believe it. They're only guessing when she was killed.
We didn't go to bed till 11, and Dick was here with us then. They can't be 8 hours adrift. Hey, Dicko, don't you see what this means? You're in the clear.
We have to take him to a shootout. We'll have to take him to a shootout.
So we're in the second 7.5 minute sudden death. Minnesota controlling, moving left to right. Nordqvist. Advocaat challenges. Lay it off to Watt. Watts cross, Coffey in the track grabs it. On goal. Coffey started to come up, then had to go back to grab that ball. Under 7 minutes to go in the second sudden death as Coffey wings it over to the far side and it's headed right back to Paul Coffey. Now to Captain Wilson.
I think Paul's a little glad to get out of that infield dirt where all 4 goals are scored against him tonight.
Van Hanegem upfield, it goes to Steve Long. Long to Christensen. He traps it. He's on McGuinigan. He leads to Long. Long in a foot race to the baseline. Tries to cross, but the ball goes over the end line, and they're going to call a goal kick. Long was just a half a step away from getting that ball right at the end line, and he had Peter Ressel and Granitza coming up, but he just couldn't quite get there in time. It went over the end line. It becomes a goal kick for Minnesota.
Nice play by Ace Netzelenga, who's been playing brilliantly all evening, both on offense and defense. One of the finer midfielders in the NASL.
With the ball, Tino Letteri, the fine Minnesota goalkeeper, to Steve Litt. Check that. Alan Merrick. Merrick comes to the net again. Nordqvist. He was looking for Morgan. Morgan didn't break. Now he tries to go to Futcher. Now back to Morgan. Futcher going into the penalty area as Morgan crosses. It goes high in the air. Trapped by Advocat. Kick back upfield. Looking for Ressel. Kicked away. Willie gets that ball on the far side. Willie on a run. Griffith's on him. Ball ends up over the end line. Let's see how they call it. It's going to be a goal kick. The kicks assumed they were going to get a corner kick, but I do believe it was a good call. Alan Willie did touch that ball last. Now we're down under 5.5 minutes remaining in the second sudden death. All tied at 4. Chicago goals. 2 by Ressel, 1 by Joburg, 1 by Dick Advocat on a penalty kick. Granitza makes the trap. Finally ends up on the foot of Steve Long. Goes to Griffiths on the far side. Griffiths coming on Alan West. Griffiths looking for the crossing pass. Puts it out to Carl Heinz. Ball knocked away from Carl. Minnesota's Nesalenkwe is there, trying to control. Ball is loose. Ressel tried to fight for it. The ball coming to the near side. Kept inbounds, however, by the Minnesota Kicks. And Nesalenkwe has it. Clock running down toward the 4.5 minute mark, remaining in the second of sudden death as Nesalenkwe starts to run. Finally, Granitza picks him up. Granitza, the sliding tackle, gets the ball. Foul called on Carl Heitz. Granitza. Free kick. McGlenahan in control, but Granitza's there. Pushes it over to Gene Strenicer. Little Gino with it. Oh, he overleads his man. McGlenahan puts it back into the penalty area, but it just skims off the top of Ace Nesalenkwe's head over the line. It's going to be a goal kick for Chicago.
That's a good look at Bruce Wilson. He's a little bit upset at Gino on that one. Gino not used to pulling the ball out from the back. Put a real hospital ball through there, and the Minnesota player took it. And he should be safe first at this point in the game.
Coffey driving the ball upfield. Joburg tries to get it with his head. He is dumped, and a foul called on Joburg for kicking. Free kick Minnesota in the midfield. Morgan got McClanahan up on the near side. He goes to him. McClanahan has a little bit of room. Nice cross, but it goes over Alan West's head, Futcher's head. And Advocat is dumped, going for the ball. Let's see, it rolls over. It's going to be the Sting's ball for sure. Futcher put Advocat down. Free kick for the Chicago Sting with just over 3 minutes remaining in the sudden second, the second to sudden death. You know, I've been saying it so well, I knew that one time I was going to blow it. Bruce Wilson back there for Chicago, the Sting. And he drives it upfield. They're looking for Long. Long can't quite get the header. Nordqvist is there. Goes to Nesalenkwe. Pushes it through to Morgan. Minnesota's coming. Nesalenkwe, his cross out in front. A shot hits the crossbar. Alan Willie hit the crossbar. Comes back to Morgan. Loose ball, McGlenahan. Coming on Long to Nesalenkwe. His cross in front. Coffey fists it outside the penalty area. But Nordqvist is there. Tries to get around Granitza. Lays it in again. Willie is out in front, but Coffey grabs it. Coffey came off the line to grab it away from Willie, and I want to tell you that my heart is just continuing to stop. Paul Granitza on the run.
Paul Coffey looks like a refugee from the Blitz in London in 1940. I'll tell you, Paul Coffey's been shell-shocked with the kids staying in there. He's a tough youngster.
Sting can't get anything going in the second sudden death. Minnesota's playing. West drives it forward. Broken up by Strenicer, driven back up midfield, but Minnesota's Merrick is there. He gets it to Nordqvist. Less than 2 minutes in the second sudden death. Nordqvist pushes it to Morgan. Dan McGlenahan. He crosses again. And it goes over Futcher's head. It's rolling off to the far side. Dick Advocato runs it down easily for the Sting. Minute and 35 to go in the sudden death. This is the second one. Ball is pushed upfield. It is intercepted by Merrick. Minnesota drives it forward to Willie. Headed away by Griffiths up to Karl-Heinz Grunitzer. Takes a bounce on Carl. Tries to go to Joburg. Taken back by Nordqvist. Plays it out. Ace Nesalenkwe. Ace outside the penalty area. Goes to McGlynn again. He got position. He crossed. Broke it up. The shot deflected by Clive Griffiths. Taken back by Willie. Headed by Griffiths away. Battle for the ball. Finally, Griffiths tries to control. Pushes it forward. 53 seconds left as Peter Russell starts to run. Goes to Christensen on the far side. 1-1 against Merrick. Oh, and he's broken up right at the top of the penalty area. Minnesota comes back with 40 seconds. To Morgan on the far side. 1-1 against Advocat. He gets by Advocat. He throws one in front, fisted away by Paul Coffey. A good move by the young American goalkeeper. Tommy Joburg starting a run. 25 seconds left. They gather in on Joburg. Makes a good move. Gets around Tony Watt. Goes to Russell. Russell again matched up against Merrick on the far side. Coming into the penalty area. He shoots. Grabbed by Tino Letteri. It's the Sting's first shot in the second sudden death. You see the scoreboard clock as the ball goes out of bounds.
Catch shootout. They want a chance at Paul Coffey. I'm sure Paul's going to be up to the test. We'll find
Chicago's
out.
Chicago's been trying
tougher.
To substitute right here. Both sides
Brett
are
Hall.
Trying to substitute.
When he was in the NASL, before he sat on the bench and has looked the last couple seasons, Tony Church, one of the fine young goalkeepers still. He's only 25 years old. We're going to go to the shootout, Howard.
There's the end of Saturday. There's Russell. He's set. Hands on his knees like an outfielder, like Don DiMaggio, waiting for a fly ball. In the nets will be Tino Letteri. And I want to tell you there is tension all over the Met at Bloomington. Again, we are in a shootout. What a ball game the Sting has played tonight, coming back three times to tie. They'll be home July 14th against Tulsa, 3:30 Wrigley Field. Here comes Russell. Shootout's on. Russell waits. He shoots. Deflected. Letteri came out and stopped him right at that three-second mark. Also good in shootouts. Hamilton's out. Chersky's out. The shot deflected. Chersky, a big save for Chicago. And now we're still 0-1 for both sides. And that they're 0-4. Or 0-1 each side. Four to go. It's tied after four shots. They each put up another shooter. Here's Wilson. And he is stopped. Wilson waited too long to get his shot. Too far. All right, here comes Litt. Chersky's out. Litt. His shot deflected. Tony Chersky has statistics like that. They do and come back and haunt you. Vim Van Hanegem. Here comes the Dutch master. And his shot is deflected. Van Hanegem trying to find the incoming. And he scores. Chersky looked at the timekeeper. He thought 5 seconds had elapsed. But Willie Morgan has put Minnesota ahead 1-0. Sting attempts Chersky 2. Here comes Carl. And his shot is deflected. The pressure. If Nesalenkwe scores, it's over. Here he comes. Chersky is out. No goal. No goal. It doesn't count. The timekeeper said no goal. It took more than the allotted 5 seconds. Nesalenkwe. Here he comes. And he scores. Tommy Joburg made it look easy. He made it look easy. The Sting has tied it at one. However, Minnesota will have the fifth kick. It's like having your outs.
Here we go. Letteri was a little bit upset at the official there. He was not ready. And that's what he's yelling about down on the field right now. Tommy Joburg took it in. Letteri did not get as far off the line as he'd like to.
Alan Willie, their leading scorer, will take it. Chersky crouched at the goal line. Here comes Willie. And it's blocked. And a super save. A tremendous pressure save by Tony Chersky. And he's on the one. Here's Long. Steve Long, the rookie from Wheaton. And he tried to chip it over the key to Chersky. Here comes Fletcher. And he misses. Fletcher goes. goes wide to the far, to the near side.
I don't think Dick likes taking these shootout players. I think they're going to...
Willie Roy, there's a shot of Roy at the bench.
Yes, it's going to be Dick Advocaat.
You just saw Lee Stern, the Chicago Sting owner, and here comes Dick Advocaat. Gutty Dick. Here comes Advocaat. Sting wants to go ahead for one time. And Advocaat scores!
Dickie doesn't like it, but he delivers.
No, they're waving it off. The timekeeper says time had run out.
That's ridiculous. It only took him about four seconds.
Here's a shot of Advocaat and Chersky arguing with the referee.
Advocaat stuck on your watch. I don't own one, but we're going to watch Dickie Advocaat on the line now. Here we go. Dickie Advocaat pushes the ball out in front, just around the 18-yard line. It looked pretty good to me, Kenny. What time do you have?
I'll tell you what, that's
disallowed due to time, and that's as controversial a call as we've seen. Nordqvist will take it. Here he comes. Game's on the line.
Let's watch it now.
It's over. They're allowing the goal. And that seemed like it took a lot longer. And what?
Our director just said it took a little bit longer. We don't want to indict anybody, but if that's...
Look at the room around the field.
I'll tell you, Howard, if that...
Unbelievable.
Goal, this game has got to go under protest. There's Lee Stern, the owner of the Sting. Lee's a little bit heated at this point.
Unbelievable. Ladies and gentlemen, we've been covering the Sting for a long time. You have yet to hear me make the statement. I will make it right now. The ball game has been stolen from the Chicago Sting. Not only did they disallow Advocaat's shot, but the shot by Nordqvist took almost 6 seconds, according to the count on the board.
Now, Lee doesn't want to do that. He's getting a little bit heated. Hopefully, somebody with Horace Blankenberg comes in there to get him off. The referee here has not had this game under control.
Escort for the referee. I want to tell you, that's for the timekeeper. Police escort for the timekeeper. An unbelievable series of events. Unbelievable series of events. The Chicago Sting a loser here in a shootout. But no one will ever convince the Sting, and we're going to be back with the final wrap-up after this word. Howard Balson with Ken Cherkin and Carl Cherkin and Ken Stern back at the Met in Bloomington, where the Sting has just been robbed of a shootout win, and our director informed us it is quite possible we may have a replay of the winning goal on the shootout, and we're going to run it at normal speed, so once again, keep your watches.
Okay, here we go. This is Bjorn Nordqvist on the ball.